get. Of course, some of you might be saying that's great because we're going to get to talk more. The teams that they have lost to, Tuscola 11-1, Brevard 10-2, Murphy 11-1. You know, Murphy not in their division, but still 11-1. So this is a team that 7-5 record is a little bit misleading.
Yeah, this is a pretty darn good team. You said teams have lost to 11-1, 11-1, 10-2, and those were close games. You know, they lost at Pisgah by 6. We know from experience that going up to Pisgah is no easy task. They lost at Tuscola game 24-8, Asheville by 1 point, Brevard by 5. You know, these are teams that are still alive in the playoffs. So Franklin comes in. Really good team on the year, 7-5. They're led by Andrew Moore, the junior quarterback. He's 6'6". And, of course, Brock Kleppel, who is their rusher, leading rusher. He's 24 yards shy of the 2,000-yard mark on the season. So he's had quite the season, and he's just a junior as well. He's 205 pounds, around 6 foot. So big running back, runs hard, and he's the workhorse for the Panthers.
Well, what's really unusual is that you got a team that runs an I formation, and Shelley hasn't seen an I formation this year. I mean, it's so strange. You know, it used to be that teams that ran the spread, they were difficult to get ready for. Now it's like the teams that run the I formation are difficult to get ready for. And the other thing to keep in mind is, you know, Kleppel is a great running back. I say 1,976 yards. He averages almost 6 yards a carry. He has 32 touchdowns. But once you start, if you spend too much time looking at him, they can give the ball to a fullback, number 31, A.J. Carpenter, or number 35, Dylan Daves. And these two guys have about 450 yards between them. And I was able to watch some of the Stuart Kramer game last week, and those fullbacks did a great deal of damage against Stuart Kramer, just running a little trap right up the middle. And when you get to really paying attention to Kleppel, then they'll hit you up the middle, and it's a real quick hitter, and they run really hard.
Well, the Panthers, of course, Kleppel is the main guy, but Andrew Moore, having a pretty good season of his own. Moore on the year has 1,661 yards passing, 11 touchdowns. But, you know, the thing that I'm looking at is 60% completion, 129 of 215. And, you know, that's even a little bit better than our own Malik Surratt. So, you know, they're not just one-dimensional. They can throw it when they need to. And they're a dangerous offense as they average 30.4 points a game. They average 240 on the ground, but 138 through the air. So more run heavy, but they're fairly balanced. You know, they're not run only.
Right. Well, Jordan Nugent, number 10, is their number one receiver. He's got 52 receptions for 587 yards. Got really good hands. And another really great receiver is the running back, Brock Kleppel, who has 273 yards rushing. 273 yards in his catching passes, but you know, he averages 16 yards a reception, and I think he played some tight end last year, and so he really has good hands. Also, both those fullbacks come out of the backfield and do a good job, and so they are quite balanced in that they're not just going to hand the ball to the tailback. They've also got a slot back, number 7, Grant Stiles, has 251 yards rushing, only 38 carries. He's again a guy that they run some reverses to, some misdirection to, and he averages almost 7 yards per carry. So they are a good team. They know what they want to do, and their offensive line does a nice job.
Yeah, Franklin Panthers coming in 7-5 again against your 12-0 Shelby Golden Lions. 2AA second round playoff action. This is the Bill Shuford Heating and Air Conditioning in-stadium pregame show. Of course, our title sponsor is Ronaldo Auto Mall. We thank them for our sponsorship. And we're going to take a 3-minute break here in our pregame show. We're going to come back with an interview with Coach Lance Ware that Jeff did pregame. And we'll do that after this 3-minute break. We'll be right back.
His brother, Gerald Coon.
Welcome back to Shelby High School, Bill Schuford, Heating and Air Conditioning, and pregame show. And Shelby versus Franklin here in the second round of the 2AA playoffs. And coach, as we look at the 2AA playoff bracket, in the West region, you've got Shelby, the number one seed in the whatever pod that we're in.
The West.
And then you've got Franklin is the 5 seed, so they upset Stuart Kramer last week, according to the seedings, although I don't really consider them upset. And then you got Huss, number 3 seed, hosting RS Central from our conference, and RS Central beat the number 2 seed, 31-6 last week. So winner of Shelby Franklin takes on Huss, and RS Central winner. And then in the other pod in the West, you've got Monroe, the number 1 seed, playing the 5 seed Mount Pleasant, the team we've played a couple of times here recently. And then on the other side, you got West Caldwell, East Lincoln, which is a pretty darn good matchup. I think maybe even a rematch from earlier in the year.
I think Mount Pleasant is also a rematch. I think Mount Pleasant and Monroe are in the same conference as well.
So you got a couple of rematches, and then of course if Shelby and RS were to win, you could have another rematch there from our conference. So as you look at the 2A, you've got Lincolnton hosting Eastern Randolph and Surrey Central hosting Hendersonville, and then in the other half you got Brevard hosting North Ryan and Reidsville hosting Mountain Heritage. And I think a lot of people are looking for a fourth round game between Lincolnton and Reidsville. And then in the 3A action, a lot of interesting scenarios there. You've got High Brighton hosting Burns from Cleveland County, and you've got West Rowan hosting Crest. So both Burns and Crest on the road tonight. But should they both win, they'll be facing each other in the third round. And then in the other pod, you've got South Point hosting Tuscola, who's the number 1 seed out of the conference that Franklin's in. And then in the other side, you've got Pisgah hosting Patton. Pisgah also in the conference. So you could have a possible Pisgah-Tuscola third round game rematch, or a Pisgah-South Point. And then, of course, looking down there, you could have a South Point-Crest or South Point-Burns or High Brighton type Western final. So a lot of interesting scenarios, and we'll try to keep you posted on those scores as the night goes along. Here it's Franklin against Shelby. And Coach, before we went to the break, we said we would get an interview from Coach Lance Ware. So let's go to that interview now.
It's time for the weekly coaches conversation with head football coach Lance Ware. Here we are getting ready for the second round playoff game, Franklin Panthers versus Shelby Golden Lions. First off, Coach, congratulations. Had an off week that you had to deal with that was completely unexpected, but then you came out and I thought you played really a solid ball game in the first round.
Played well in all three phases. Didn't run a lot of plays offensively. Scored quick. Defense scored on their own in the second half. So we didn't get a lot of plays offensively in the second half, but good to get a win and advance.
Well, it's always a special week when you get to play on Thanksgiving weekend. Tell everybody about how the Thanksgiving week is a little bit different for the team.
Well, we kind of, we're out of school Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and we bring them in at 10 o'clock, practice Wednesday morning, bring them back Thursday night at 8, and a lot of community members come out and watch, fans, and, try and give them as much time off in between to do what they have to do with their families, and then walk through on Thursday, ready to go Friday.
Well, standing here looking at tall quarterback for Franklin and really good good running back, almost got 2,000 yards for the season. So what are we looking for tonight in this football game?
That tall quarterback's going to turn around and hit it off that and good running back. He's a physical runner, downhill, eye backfield. They like to get the ball in his hands, and he's kind of their bell cows. That's who we got to stop.
Looks like they like to do a little play action pass too, and also got to say that looked to me like their fullbacks run pretty hard on the old buck trap of the middle.
Yeah, little buck trap. You don't see this much anymore with high formation, offset fullback power football, but it's worked for them, and we've had a good week of preparation, so be interested to see how our defense plays.
Well, thanks very much, Coach. Good luck, and hopefully we'll be talking to you next week.
Thank you, Jeff.
That was Coach Lance Ware. Pre-game just a moment ago. Shelby Band takes the field. They'll be playing the alma mater and the national anthem here shortly. And the cheerleaders are taking the field to hold up the banner. Got about 13 and a half minutes still to go before kickoff. And so, Coach, we talked a little bit about that offense for Franklin. And one of the things that I noted this week, and I think I was even posted some stats on NC Prep's website, was that I thought the key to the matchup tonight was going to be the Franklin offense against the Shelby defense, because when you look at the stats, they're so polar opposite that something's got to give.
Well, absolutely. As you mentioned that they average 30 points per game, and we only give up 8 points per game. They average 242 yards rushing per game. We give up 50 rushing per game. Total yards, they end up with 380 yards per game. We give up 119. So I think you're absolutely correct. Unstoppable force, immovable object, kind of thing. But on the other side, you don't talk much about the Franklin defense, and there's probably a reason for that. They're giving up about 21 points per game.
Yeah, which you would think plays a little bit into Shelby hands, because Shelby's averaging over 40 points a game. You're playing a team giving up 20. It's a little bit less of a spread than when you look at 30-8. And so you got to think that Shelby offense can put some points up tonight. So the defense just has even a somewhat off game, Shelby should be in good shape. But you just never know. You got to play the game. And I'll tell you what, we're getting ready for the alma mater and then the national anthem. So it's a good time for another break on this Bill Shuford Heating and Air Conditioning pregame show. Back in 3 minutes.
Considering hardwood flooring for your home? Then head to Flooring America in Kings Mountain or Carpet One Interiors in Ranlow. Right now at both locations, you'll find a big selection of in-stock hardwoods on sale, priced as low as $2.99 a square foot. That's right, only $2.99 a square foot. At Flooring America, 602 Slater Street in Kings Mountain and Carpet One Interiors in Ranlow.
We all hear about how good the barbecue is in Lexington, Greensboro, and in eastern North Carolina. But here in Cleveland County, we all know that the best barbecue is here. At Ashton Bridges Barbecue, Kent and Linda Bridges and their family make sure the staple of their restaurant is the best barbecue. Your choice, pork, beef, or chicken, plus delicious sides such as slaw, beans, fries, and hush puppies. The best since Ashton and Mabel opened in 1955. Alston Bridges Barbecue, 620 Grover Street, right here in Shelby.
Former club members Denzel Washington and Jennifer Lopez for the Boys and Girls Clubs.
Every child follows a path in life. For many, that path will lead them to a door that gives them a place to grow, to learn, to belong, a place to forge their future.
You can change a child's future. Support your local Boys and Girls Clubs. Great futures start here.
You can open doors for children to have great futures at the Boys and Girls Club of Cleveland County. Visit us at 412 West Sumter Street or at greatfutures.org.
Hi, this is Woody Durham for Drs. Doug Strau, Jim Wilson, and Craig Thompson at Family Dental Care in Shelby. No matter the age, kids, teenagers, and adults, Drs. Stroud, Wilson, and Thompson will take care of your dental needs. They have over 50 years' experience serving the people of Cleveland County. Call 704-482-3281 for Family Dental Care at 416 West Warren Street in Shelby. That's Drs. Doug Stroud, Jim Wilson, and Craig Thompson. Kids love them, and you will too.
S&M Sports Shop is now your dealer for Under Armour sports apparel in Cleveland County. Come by and see the selection of Under Armour shirts, shorts, shoes, socks, and sunglasses. The team at S&M, Mike, Suzanne, Luke, Shannon, Dale, Ken, Darren, Dennis, and Charlie, is now your team outfitter for all local schools and whatever sport you play. They have leather jackets for all local high schools. Plus, S&M is your headquarters for Oakley sunglasses. For all your athletic needs, go to S&M Sports Shop, located at 707 South Lafayette Street in Shelby.
Get it on.
to Shelby High School, Bill Schuford Heating and Air Conditioning pregame show with Brent Pasco and Jeff Jones. We got Steve Roberts back at Studio Central. Of course, Steve DeGree is going to help us out with some defensive stats tonight and keep us up to date on the scores from around the state, really, for the playoff tonight. Second round action, and Coach, about 10 minutes before kickoff, and we talked a lot about that Franklin offense and the Shelby defense, and how about the Shelby offense? You got an offense that was dealt some adversity midseason, lost one of our key offensive weapons, and had some guys had to step into some different roles. Guys like Truck Sims had to convert from a slot receiver to starting tailback. Malik McMullins came in basically from off the bench, if you would, and filled in for Sims at a receiver spot, and is also playing a little bit of tight end. And then you got Devin Gillette, who comes over from the safety spot, and he's going to be sort of the change of pace running back for Sims. And Shelby hasn't really missed a beat when you look at the points that they're putting up on the board.
Well, on top of that, you also talk about, you know, halfway through the season, Shelby was playing the third center that they had. And, you know, there's been, you know, some adversity up front with the offensive line, but overall they have played quite well, you know, even when they've had to plug in some other people. And I think it was the drawn game was the first time, you know, since the very beginning of the season that Shelby had had their entire offensive line that they thought was going to start the year. Of course, one of the things about that is when you do have to go on your second and third deep, they do get a lot of playing time, and that does help out, you know, when you do have a situation where you got to bring somebody back in. So I would say that, you know, G. Hargrove has been one of the guys who's played pretty much every snap on the offensive line. And, you know, I had a couple people ask me, said, what happened to G. Hargrove because you never mentioned him? Well, that's a mark of a good offensive lineman when you never mention him, because that just means he's probably not got any holding penalties, he's not jumped off sides, he's just done his job. And so, you know, G. Hargrove, who played defensive line last year, called his name a lot, making tackles, you know, behind the line of scrimmage and things like that, but now he's been an offensive lineman, he's done a really good job. So, you know, Mike Wilbanks has had a good year with that offensive line, and that has really, you know, helped pave the way. Now, if I am Franklin football staff, the perfect game would be for Franklin to get the ball and hold on to the football, have Kleppel and the fullbacks, you know, just pound that ball up the middle, take about 6 minutes, 7 minutes, you know, make first downs, keep that Shelby defense on the field and score a touchdown, and then get a stop on for Shelby, a three and out for Shelby, get the ball back and you know, drive it down the field. You know, not unlike Brent Pasco, your NC State Wolfpack did today. I mean, you know, we're looking at somewhat of a similar situation in that State wants to run the ball on the ground, and you know, Carolina wanted to, you know, throw the ball all over the place, and you know, Shelby, you know, being a little bit like that, and so State got up 14-0, and you know, pretty much never looked back after that.
It's going to be big for sure for Franklin to ball control, keep that Shelby offense off the field and the defense on the field. And you know, one thing we haven't really talked about much this year, Shelby's never trailed by even a point all season. I don't want to jinx the guys, but you know, the closest they came was AC Reynolds in the third quarter tied the game at 14-all in the second week of the season, then Shelby pulled away. And Crest, right before halftime in the last week of the regular season, scored a touchdown to tie it at 6 and missed the extra point that could have put them in ahead 7-6 at the half and given Shelby their first deficit, but they missed the extra point. And the Shelby never trailed again in that game. So, you know, Shelby has not trailed, not even given up an opening score. And so we don't know how the Shelby team would react in the hole. And so if I'm Franklin, that's my goal, is get the lead and see what Shelby does.
Absolutely. And the other thing that you have to, you know, you wonder about, you know, as far as Franklin's concerned, have they seen the speed that they will see out of Shelby? They did have some difficulty. They gave up a lot of points to Irwin, and Irwin runs the spread, and they had some good speed out of their receivers and running backs, and that really gave Franklin a hard time. So that's what Shelby wants to do. Shelby wants to show that speed, and hopefully something that Franklin's not been able to deal with.
Yeah, you mentioned that Irwin game, 57 points by Irwin that game. Franklin scored 34, so they scored 34 and lost by three touchdowns. So, you know, this is a team that has a little bit of trouble stopping the offense, but they can put points up. So, it'll be interesting to see for sure what's going to have to give. Players are out there for the coin toss for Shelby. It's the quartet of Truck Sim, C.J. Ross, Jaden Borders, and Darius Clark, four seniors. For visitors, I see 35 Dylan Dave, 33 Logan Talent, 74 Colton Cochran, who's an offensive lineman, and number 10 Jordan Nugent, who's the receiver you talked about with 52 catches. So, you know, defensive for wise for Franklin, they've got 33 out there, Logan Talent, and as I look at their stats, he's the leading tackler by 30 tackles. He's got 95 tackles, which is 30 more than their second guy. He's also got 7 sacks, which is 4 more than anybody on the team on the season. So he's also forced 3 fumbles. So, you know, he's probably their top defensive player.
Shelby did win the toss, and so no surprise there. Shelby's going to receive the ball.
Shelby will receive the ball, and I'll tell you what, we'll take one last 2-minute timeout, and we'll come back with the Jim and Jay's Pizza Factory kickoff. It's going to be Franklin kicking to Shelby, and Shelby will be going right to left away from the field house, and we'll do that after the 2-minute break.
For the best pizza in town, it's got to be Jammin' J's Pizza Factory in Shelby. Located at 1011 Grove Street, just off Highway 74 Bypass East. It's fun for the entire family at Jammin' J's Pizza Factory. Call or stop by and let Jammin' J's Pizza Factory take care of your takeout and catering needs. You'll find specialty pizzas, including liver mush pizza and bacon cheeseburger pizza, Philly cheesesteak, subs and wings, and delivery is available for all catering orders. And they offer discount rates for schools and churches. Jammin' J's Pizza Factory, 1011 Grover Street, off Highway 74 East in Shelby, open 7 days a week.
Here's a trivia question for you. What insect in the whole world is responsible for 1 million human deaths a year worldwide? Believe it or not, it's the mosquito. That's right, the tiny mosquito. Be ready this year for the mosquito invasion with a call to H&H Termite and Pest Control of Shelby. And what about termites? Did you know they do more damage to homes than fires, tornadoes, hurricanes, and floods combined? It might be time to make that call right now. H&H Termite and Pest Control. Call 704-482-2847. 704-482-2847. Make that call today.
No matter what size vehicle you drive, Fastway Oil Change in Shelby can do your dirty work. In just minutes, you'll be on your way at Fastway Oil Change, featuring Pennzoil and Shell Oil products, along with a full line of synthetics. They do the big trucks too, tractor trailers, rollbacks, motorhomes, and dump trucks. And they are a full North Carolina inspection station. And they'll check your fluids, windshield wipers, and they carry X-Side batteries. Fastway Oil Change, 630 South Lafayette Street in Shelby. Let them do the dirty work for you.
Welcome back to Shelby High School. Time for Jim and Jay's Pizza Factory kickoff. It'll be Edgar Chavez for Franklin, senior place kicker. He's got it teed up. Back deep for Shelby is Isaiah Etchison and Jaden Borders. Up backs are Devin Gillette and Truck Sims. And we're ready for 2AA playoff action. Second round, Shelby will receive. Brilliant night for football. Not much of a chill in the air. Surprising for Thanksgiving weekend and Thanksgiving. Happy Thanksgiving to all. It's a short kick taken by Devin Gillette at the 27. He's up across the 35, still on his feet, and I think he's across to about the 39 before he's forced out of bounds. So Shelby will take over with their opening possession at their own 39-yard line. Starting lineup for Shelby offense will be wide receivers Jaden Borders, Malik McMillan, Mullins, Darius Fuller, Isaiah Etchison. It'll be Truck Sims in the backfield with Malik Surratt. Lineman will be G. Hartgrove, Turner Smith, Darius Archie, Darius Clark, and Michael Wright.
Shelby comes up with a tight end this time.
And Surratt to throw on first down, gets pressure from the outside, and he's got Malik McMullins on the drag route, but went through his hands, incomplete. And McMullins open, but maybe just a little hot and high.
And McMullins was a tight end that time, and again, it's pretty unusual for Shelby to come out first play with a tight end.
It was, and now Mullins out in the slot, so he's shifted out a hair. And Borders has coverage by Tyler Harrison on the outside. And creeping up is a linebacker, and it's going to be a fake handoff pass out in the flat to Etchison, and he's got a completion. Fly comes in from behind. That's usually a bad sign for maybe a holding penalty on the Golden Lions. Let's see the call. Gain of about 5 on the play. But let's see what the call is. Holding Shelby. So that's going to negate a 5-yard pickup. And in fact, they're going to call the hold from the spot where he was tackled. So it's going to be 10 yards, but it's going to be a net loss of just 5, as Etchison's going to get credit for a 5-yard reception. And then the penalty backs him up 10. It's going to be second down, 15. Ball back at the Shelby 34-yard line. Again, linebacker creeps up. In motion goes Etchison, and Surratt back to pass again. He's got time, and he hits Etchison on the drag. It's complete. He's out to the 39, so he gets the 5 yards back that they lost on the penalty, but it's going to bring up third down and 10.
But very impressed thus far with the tackling. Franklin's done a great job making that tackle one-on-one. I mean, they tackled Etchison both times, and he could have gotten a lot more yardage had he got out of that first tackle.
Third down and 10, as they have completed 2 passes to Etchison, both for just 5 yards. But the penalty basically negated all that yardage, and it's third down and 10. And Surratt back to pass, and he gets the screen pass off to Truck Sims, complete. He's at the 45. First down, he's across midfield, down the sideline, and he may not be touched. He's at the 10-5. Touchdown, Golden Lions. I don't see a penalty flag down, so that's going to be a 61-yard touchdown pass from Malik Surratt to Truck Sims. And the Golden Lions strike first with 10:48 to go in the first quarter as they lead 6-0. And you got to love that, Coach. Nice play call.
That was a perfect play because they brought the house, and Shelby ran a screen, made 3 good blocks, and there was nobody there. Great call, great throw, great catch, great run.
And Truck Sims ran away from that defense. Ethan tripling on for the point after. It's up. And it's good. 10:48 to go. Shelby 7. Franklin nothing. We'll be back in 30 seconds for a Jim and Jay's Pizza Factory kickoff.
Join the Balls as we broadcast live Tuesday, November 29th from 10 a.m. till 1 p.m. at the new Hospice Store Grand Opening. We'll have special giveaways, and Dairy Queen will be there too. The new store will open at 1450 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby in the former Mabry office location. Shop now for Christmas. You'll find it all at the new Hospice Store. Again, join us for the Grand Opening Tuesday, November 29th from 10 a.m. till 1 p.m. at the former Mabry office location, 1450 East Dixon Boulevard, Shelby.
Back to Shelby High School. We're working on a few mic issues. We're getting some feedback that we're a little hot on the mic, so we're going to wait for the next break and we'll try to fix that. Shelby leads 7-0. Marburger Motors touchdown. 61-yard pass from Malik Surratt to Truck Sims. And Chase Hendricks kickoff driven back to the 9-yard line, and that's Kleppel on the return. So I'm guessing Kleppel does a little bit of everything for Franklin. First down and 10, and looks like they'll start at the 27th. So Franklin, not great field position. Yeah, I guess, Coach, you say if you can keep it inside the 30, you consider it a win. So that's a win for the Shelby coverage team. Andrew Moore, the quarterback, 6'6". Behind him is Brock Kleppel. 1,976 yards on the season, 32 touchdowns rushing. And back to pass on first down is Moore, and he airs it out. And he's got Nugent down the sideline, and he had a step on Josh Smith, but it was overthrown, incomplete.
Interesting. Shelby definitely expecting some running plays, and so they've got five down linemen, three linebackers, and so it's a little bit different, look than you generally see out of Shelby. And Franklin trying to take advantage of that on the pass, but overthrew the receiver. And again, that was Nugent, who is their number one receiver, just overthrew him by about 5 yards.
Second down, 10. Shelby with a six-man front. And it is Kleppel on the handoff, and O.J. Ross hits him immediately, and he's dropped for maybe half a yard loss. Nice penetration by Big 95. And they're going to call it no gain. So Kleppel's first carry is a win for the Golden Lions. Front four, front seven. Now it's third down and 10 for the Panthers. And kind of an offset eye, Nugent in motion, fake rollout, and Moore's going to air it out. And he's got a man, Nugent, behind the defense as Aaron Jolly's failed, but it's overthrown, incomplete. And that's going to bring up fourth and 10. Shelby got a little bit lucky there as Jolly just lost his footing.
Yeah, it's really unusual to see a receiver ring wide open. And, again, Frank couldn't ask for a better situation. Nugent was, you know, I said he was 5 yards behind Jolly because Jolly had fallen down. And had he caught that ball, he might have scored.
I'm hearing that West Rowan is up 7-0 pressed early. We'll keep tabs on those scores from around the area. And back to punt, high snap, and it's Moore to do the punt. And he goes up and gets it, and it's going to be a short kick, bounces twice, and then fielded at 25 by Jaden Borders. He's to the 27-30, to the 35, and breaks the tackle up to the 38. So nice return by Borders as he has to run backwards to field the ball on two bounces.
That was a 48-yard punt by Moore.
So Shelby takes over, leading 7-0 with 9:43 to go on the Miracle Arts Pharmacy scoreboard. And again, Shelby takes over at their own 39-yard line. So that's two straight possessions. Shelby starts in the same spot. Surratt back to throw, and he goes for McMullins. McMullins loses his footing at the 50-yard line. He was doing a curl route and probably would have made the catch, but he slipped on the curl, and it falls incomplete. Second down and 10 for Shelby.
So that's two times Shelby has lost their footing on the field, and the field looks like it's in fine shape.
It does. Very little rain for quite some time. And second and 10, Devin Gillette comes into the game, and Shelby's got receivers stacked both right and left, one right behind each other. And it's going to be a handoff to Gillette, and he's up the middle, and he's through the secondary, and he gets still on his feet, and he's driving for a Pekin Insurance first down as he gets into Panther territory at the 49-yard line, and that's a pickup of 12 for Gillette. So we forgot to do it, but let's do our West End Sales players to watch tonight. I'm going to go Devin Gillette since I mentioned him in the pregame, and I'll let you get defense.
Well, I'll go Dax Hollifield because you know they're going to try to run that football.
High Brighton's taking a 7-0 lead over Burns. First and 10, Shelby, 9:29 to go first quarter. Clock running, Shelby up 7-0. Devin Gillette stays in. Now Shelby comes in with bunched receivers just outside the tackles. Again stacked on the left hash, and it's a pitch forward to Borders. And he's got blocking, and he's across the 40, and he's got a first down, and that's going to be a pass. That's a shovel pass to the 34 of Franklin. That's a 15-yard gain for Shelby. And a Pekin Insurance first down.
Shelby's got to feel good when you got guys going around the ends because they've got such a great speed differential over Franklin.
And Shelby on the move. Again, Franklin, they're creeping up the linebacker, 22, Zach Dela Cruz. And a false start on Shelby's going to back it up 5 yards. Going to be first down and 15, and that's going to back it up to the Franklin 39-yard line.
Yeah, Franklin has shown in the film that we've seen, you know, especially last week,
they do a lot of, you know, safety blitzes, corner blitzes, and Shelby trying to be aware of that, and just one of the guys twitched.
First down pass to Jaden Borders in the flat, and it's complete. And he's across the 30, 25 still on his feet, and inside the 20, and he's going to be all the way down to the 18-yard line. And, gosh, that's a pig and returns first down.
What a great block by number 11, Malik McMullins. I mean, he hooked up with that cornerback and drove him out of bounds. That was a great block.
It's a 21-yard reception, and Shelby really moving the ball well here early. That's a 21-yard pickup. Surratt, two Borders. And on first down, it's Gallette, and he's got a hole. He's at the 15-10, hurdles a man down to about the 3. And Shelby's going to have first and goal with another Pegram Insurance first down for the Golden Lions.
Shelby leads 7-0 with 8:39 left here in the first quarter. Looking for more. First and goal, 3-yard line.
15-yard pickup by Gallette. And he stays in the ball game, and it looks like he's going off to the right side, and he finds a hole, and he reaches for the goal line. No signal, and they say he's down short. And I'll tell you,
well, he got the ball in the end zone, but they're going to say his knee was down, and, you know, that's not outside the realm of believability. He did a great job. He was hit on about the 3-yard line, and he dragged one of the defenders down to the goal line with him.
Second and goal, ball on the 1, probably maybe just inside the 1-yard line. Gallette stays in the game, and he'll get the call. Actually, it's a pass play over the middle, and that's a touchdown. Darius Fuller, and that was a nice call. Fakes the handoff, the linebacker's bit, and then Fuller just does a slant, and Surratt hits it. 1-yard touchdown reception for Fuller, and with 7:56 to go here in the first quarter, Shelby's up 13-0 on the Mobile Arts Pharmacy scoreboard. Second touchdown pass of the game for Malik Surratt here in the first quarter. Triplet on for the point after. Fuller will stay in to do the holding. Great snap, good hold, kicks up. And just like that, Shelby leads 14-0. We'll be back in 30 seconds for a Jim and Jay's Pizza Factory kickoff.
Get the cutting edge. Get the commercial grade with Kubota's new Z700 Series Commercial Zero Turn Mower that raises the bar for quality, durability, precision, and all-around value from Parker Farm Service in Kings Mountain. No other mower in its class even comes close. Cut with the best. Cut with the Kubota Z700 with a comprehensive 2-year warranty. See Parker Farm Service, 126 Bessie Drive in Kings Mountain. Ask for the new Kubota Z700.
Back to Shelby High School. Marburger Motors touchdown pass, 1 yard from Malik Surratt to Darius Fuller in a play that pretty much surprised everybody. Everybody was expecting a run, and Shelby comes with the pass. And it's a touchdown, 14-0 Shelby. Not even midway through the first quarter. Kleppel from the 10, he's got a head of steam. He's taken down right around the 30. And as you would imagine, the two keys combined for the tackle. You know, these are two guys coming with 18 and 15 tackles respectively. That's 33 tackles, pretty much all on special teams. Those are those guys that would, you know, in the NFL, they name a special teams all pro. Those guys would be in it, representing Shelby for sure. First and 10, ball at the 31 for Franklin as they start their drive number 2, already down 14 points to Shelby.
Shelby did a good job not jumping that time on the hard count.
And Kleppel around the left side, and he does a good job to break some tackles, but then he's hit pretty hard by Brandon Davis, I believe.
Well, you can see, you know, he did a great job of getting around the tackle. It looked like he might be hit for a 2-yard loss, but he actually snuck down inside that tackle and picked up 4 yards, a second down and 6.
Yeah, and he got a good forward progress because he was really nailed by Davis and went backwards a yard, but they gave him forward progress up to the 35. But good pickup of 4. And more under center. Now the offset is to the right, and Nugent goes in motion. And it's going to be the handoff to Kleppel. And he's hit in the backfield, and this time he's not going to get any more. And they actually, I don't even I don't even think he got to the 34, and they're almost saying he got to the line of scrimmage by the mark. That's a very generous mark.
Yeah, very generous mark, but what a great job by the goal line front four, all of them in the backfield that time. Again, got to look for a hard count here, try to draw Shelby off, because you know, they got film from last week's game, and Shelby jumped off sides about 8 times in that game. And so I would be shocked if we don't have a hard count to begin with.
Third down, 6. And Moore rolls out right, play action, and he's got a man open. It's complete to 35, and that's Dylan Davis, but he's hit immediately. Was that C.J. Ross, 23, and they're going to be shy. A good 3 yards shy of the first down. So that's only a pickup of 3 by Daves. And so it's a great tackle.
So it's going to be 4th down and 3. And with the quarterback being the punter, and looks like they may be going for it though. They're going to stay in this I formation, and they're going to say, we're going to go for it.
4th down and 3, hard count. Shelby stays put, 18 on the play clock. They could line up and try a hard count again. Shelby almost jumps, but stays put. C.J. Ross kind of flinched, but good thing is he's a good yard off the line of scrimmage. And now with 3 on the play clock, 2-1, and they're either going to call a timeout or take a delay game, and they're going to call a timeout. So we'll take one, too. We'll be back in 1 minute. Shelby's going to have to call a timeout because they only have 10 men on the field.
Timeout, Shelby.
Actually, they had 11 men on the field, and the 12th man ran onto the field.
And Shelby has two receivers back. I mean, they've got Truck and Jaden Borders back there for the punt. And Frank came out in the I formation again. I mean, and why not? I mean, it's 4th down and 3, but you're down 14-0. And, you know, why not go for it? You're in a situation where at first two series, the defense hasn't stopped Shelby from doing anything. And so 4th down and 3, why not go for it? Try to make a statement. So if you don't get it, Shelby's going to get it deep inside your territory. But, again, you haven't stopped them yet anyway. So
they come back out 4th and 3 yards, and they're going for it. Line up in the eye. It's a kind of a trap play to 7, and that is your guy Styles that you mentioned will get it on those kind of plays. He's set for a loss.
Got a penalty flag in there, and it looks like that would be a flag on Franklin on a block. And it is. It's a hold on Franklin. That's going to be declined by Shelby, and so Shelby's going to take the ball at the Franklin 35-yard line.
So they go for it, and they lose 3 yards. As Styles not fooled, or Shelby not fooled at all. And loss of 3 by Styles, and Shelby takes over in great field position at the Franklin 35-yard line. And they already lead 14-0 with 5:29 to go here in the first quarter. And Franklin looked like 22. He keeps on showing blitz. That's Zach Dela Cruz. This time he comes into the neutral zone, but they say he was drawn offsides. So that's a 5-yard penalty on the Golden Lions. And that backs it up to the 40-yard line.
Yeah, I didn't see that at all, but didn't matter what I saw, did it?
Did not. And we're going to pull something here in a minute. Next break, we're gonna switch over to Skype. Might get a clearer picture. And on 1st and 15, Surratt gets blitzed, and he has to pull it in and run. And he gets a couple. or the penalty yards back. Let's call it two.
Yeah, I was wondering, you know, what Franklin was going to try to do because, you know, last week North Surrey tried to just rush three and drop eight, and that didn't work. So Franklin looks like they're going to say, let's just go ahead and blitz the house and see if we can cause a little bit of disruption on the Shelby front, and it worked that time.
So second down, 13, and I think Franklin is guilty this time of coming in the neutral zone. His nose tackle was a little early, so Shelby gets five back, and now a second and 13 turns into a second down and eight. So I downloaded this Max Preps app, and I liked some of the teams in our bracket, and what it's doing is giving me minute-by-minute scores as long as people are sending those in. So I got High Brighton 7-0 over Burns. I got West Rowan 7-0 over Crest.
Quick throw out in the flat to Etchison, and Etchison gets almost to the first down, stops, and he just gets drilled. So it's going to be third down and a long one, a short two, quick throw out in the flat to Etchison.
Yeah, so they're going to give him 6 yards, and it's going to be third down and two. And so Etchison with three catches for 16 yards here early. Third and two, and you got to think this may be four down territory for Shelby as far down as they are. Hand off to Truck Sims. He's got a first down and more. He's spin move inside the 20, 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, Truck Sims, as he's got his second highlight reel touchdown of the night. And this one is a 32-yard touchdown. I think 32. No. Let me rephrase that. 27-yard touchdown. I was 5 yards off. 27-yard run for a touchdown by Truck. And he's now got two touchdowns on the night, one receiving, one rushing. Ethan tripling on for the point after. And it's good. Shelby 21, Franklin nothing. 3:53 to go first quarter. We'll be back right after this.
ENT Carolina is not your parents' allergy treatment. Now, no shots, no pain, no fear. Ask about the sublingual immunotherapy. Drops are placed under your tongue, and just 2 minutes a day is all it takes. It's safe, effective, and you do it on your own schedule. And best of all, no weekly doctor visits. Call today for a consultation with one of their board-certified allergy specialists. Visit a location near you. ENT Carolina, 2520 Aberdeen Road in Gastonia, 1212 Spruce Street in Belmont, and 1180 White Road in Shelby. Experience, quality, and guaranteed service. That's what you get from Shelby Transmission Specialists. They do straight drives and automatic transmissions. They can repair and rebuild transmissions, and they sell parts as well. So if you have transmission trouble, see the experts, Hal, Lau, Jimmy, and Billy at Shelby Transmission Specialists, 734 Nally Drive, just off Highway 226 North in Shelby. Call 704-482-8756 for Shelby Transmission Specialists.
Shelby High School, and Golden Lions lead 21-0 over Franklin. And Franklin starts this drive after the Kleppel return at about the 25-yard line. And it's going to be an uphill battle from here. Hand off to Stiles, and he's hit in the backfield by CJ or OJ Ross. And OJ's had a pretty darn good game. That's the second time he's been in the backfield tonight for a loss of yardage.
That's two times that they tried to give it to Stiles on kind of the sort of the jet sweep, and that's been a big no-go on both those. So he's got two carries for a loss of four. And now Franklin's going to go into shotgun, and they are not terribly comfortable in the shotgun.
And there's a penalty flag before the play. Use
obviously a neutral zone infraction or a false start, and it's going to be Franklin guilty of the false start. So it's going to back it up 5, and it's going to bring up a second down and 17 back at the 19.
And, you know, when you get to a situation where you get a team out of their comfort zone, because, you know, Franklin wants to line up in I formation and pound you. It's 21-0, 3 minutes left in the first quarter. Now Franklin's in the shotgun. Now, not saying that they can't throw out of this, because their quarterback, you know, 6'6", got a good arm. He's had a couple open receivers. He just hadn't made the completion. Snap back and throw over the middle, and he's got, oh my goodness, he has number 10, again, his number one receiver, Jordan Nugent, and he hits him right in the hands, and Nugent just cannot pull it in. So, again, that would have been good for a first down, Brent, but just couldn't make the reception. So it's going to be third down and 17, Franklin on their own 19-yard line. 2:47 left in the first quarter. Shelby leads 21-0.
And that was a really good pass, and like you said, it hit off Nugent's fingertips and almost picked off by Damian Key on the tip. So it's third down 17 now, and again, more in the shotgun. And Shelby's showing blitz, but now drops back into coverage. And they're going up top, and they got Kleppel running a fly pattern down the sideline, but Josh Smith is step for step with him, and it falls incomplete. And that's going to be fourth down and 17, and I've got a feeling they might not go for this one.
Well, Kleppel's got great hands, and so if you're gonna throw up a fly pattern to somebody, I've seen him make some great catches up to this point. And Shelby, you know, right in a perfect defense pretty much every time. So two receivers back, Moore, the quarterback, in punt formation. 2:41 left in the first quarter. Shelby leads 21-0.
And Moore, no rush, and he gets away a pretty good punt. It goes over the head of Jaden Borders. Now, he may have touched it. Truck Sims is going to pick it up at the 27, and he's at the 35, 40, 45, 50, 45, 40. Cuts back. He may have stepped out of bounds, and he did, but not until he was at the Franklin 40-yard line. He never did run full speed. He had a wall of blockers and hit the sideline, and nice job by that Shelby return team.
Yeah, that was a 54-yard punt by Moore. And, again, Truck took his time, picked it up, and then just went straight down the sideline and followed his blockers.
Burns trails High Brighton 21-0. Crest trails West Rowan 14-0. And Malik Surratt on first down rolls out and has pressure from 41 Byron Shields and has to get rid of it a little earlier than he wanted to, and it falls incomplete, second down 10.
Second straight possession that Shelby's going to start up deep. Well, actually, it's not deep into Franklin territory, but it is on Franklin 40.
So, second and 10, Devin Gillette's their tailback. And again, the stack sets, this time wide, Shelby on the left hash. Still first quarter, and Surratt goes short to Borders, who catches it, gets hit, breaks a tackle. And he's going to power forward for about 8, maybe 7.
Yeah, Borders caught that ball on about the 35-yard line, got out of a tackle immediately, then ran in between 3 tacklers and ran over one of them to pick up almost 9 yards. That was a really good run after the catch. Third down and a short 2.
Third and 2 it is, and Surratt looks to the sideline for the call from Coach Emery. Again, the stack receivers, but this time just to the left. High snap, handoff to Gillette, and he picks a hole. He's at the 25, 20, hurdles, 15, and down inside the 10, and now flags come all over the place.
I think it's illegal to jump over somebody in high school.
He just did a Vince Carter. He literally hurdled a guy that was standing up straight.
And it sounds crazy, but I do think it's illegal to hurdle somebody. And it's a safety issue, because if you try to hurdle and they stand up, I mean, you could be in some serious difficulty. But it's going to be enough for the first down, even if it's a 15-yard. I don't know what the penalty is for hurdling somebody, but that's what it's going to be.
The line of scrimmage was the 32.
So they call it unsportsmanlike conduct. So hurdling someone on the field of play, Brent Pascoe, is unsportsmanlike conduct.
Wow. Whatever the case, it was a highlight reel run. Reidsville 10, Mountain Heritage 0.
And it should give Shelby a first down there.
So they, and the penalty was marked off from where he jumped, not where he ended. So he jumped at the 15. He made it to the 8, but the penalty's from the 15. So we'll give him from the 32 to the 15. So that's what, 17-yard run that he'll have. Then a 15-yard penalty, but it's going to be first and 10 Shelby. You don't see that penalty. That's the first time I've ever seen it called in a high school game. Now Gillette goes out wide, and Surratt's going to tuck it, and he's going to run, and he's got a first down. There might be a hold back here, as there was the Shelby right side of the O-line. One of those two is going to get called, I think, for a hold.
It is going to be a holding penalty. The good news is it's not going to be one of those penalties that's like 5 or 6 yards beyond the line of scrimmage. It's going to be about 2 yards behind the line of scrimmage. So it's going to be first and 22 for Shelby. But it's kind of unfortunate that we had the holding penalty because Surratt made a good decision and he was going to pick up about 11 yards that time.
So it's going to be first and 22, like you said. So Shelby's got 27 yards in penalties on the last two plays, and the good news is it's still first down and they're still in Franklin territory, but now at the 42, handoff to Gillette around the right side, and he's trying to get to the outside, but he runs out of real estate and he's going to be tackled for just a short gain. Actually, he's run out of bounds for a short gain. Let's see if they even give him a yard. I think they do give him 1 yard. So it'll be to the 41. So now it's second down and 21 for Shelby.
Second down and 21.
Gillette having a nice first quarter. He's carried it 5 times for 47 yards. And 3 receivers left to the wide side of the field. And the lone receiver to the right is Fuller, who's got a 1 yard touchdown catch. Clock is under 30 seconds here in the first quarter. This may be the last play. And Surratt's going deep, and he's got Fuller behind the defense, and he's got it. Touchdown, Shelby, 41 yards, and Fuller's got his second touchdown reception of the game, and Surratt's got his third touchdown pass of the game, and Shelby up 27 to nothing on the Medical Arts Pharmacy scoreboard here in the first quarter. Still 12.6 seconds. To go, and Ethan Triplett's on for his fourth point after attempt already. Low snap, and Fuller does a great job, and Triplett hits it. So Shelby 28, and Franklin nothing. We'll be back in 30 seconds.
Doctor, what's wrong with my husband?
Let's take a look.
CK, DK, DS, Macron.
Yes, I've seen this before. Your husband has coyote fever.
Coyote fever?
Yes, he's obviously learned of the hot deals going on now at your local coyote tractor dealer.
Is this serious?
Very serious. Now is the best time to buy one of the best-selling tractors on the market. If you care at all about your husband, you'll drive him over to the coyote dealer now. Oh, and I'm writing you a prescription for great deals on all implements, too.
Your Coyote dealer is West End Sales, Highway 1827 intersection in Vail.
Harburger motor touchdown, 41-yard pass from Malik Surratt to Darius Fuller. Shelby up 28-0 in the first quarter, folks. 12.6 seconds to go on the Medical Arts Pharmacy scoreboard. All Golden Lions so far. Chase Hendricks does another kickoff, and they've switched, and it's 22 from the 10-yard line. And that's the guy that's been creeping up, Zach De La Cruz. And I may have that number wrong. That's 28. So that's Ethan McCall on the return, and he gets it out to 29?
Yep, 29. Well, they're going to say the 30. So.
Okay. So Franklin takes over at the 30. They've started at their 27, 31, 26, and now they're 30. And, Coach, I don't know if they've had a first down.
No, they have not.
Okay, first and 10 from the 30. And in motion goes 45 Kleppel. Hand off to the fullback, And again, Shelby all over it. Dax Hollifield and Joslyn McGill with a little bit of help from Rajay Kirkland. And that's the end of one. Shelby 28, Franklin nothing. We'll take a 1 minute break. We'll be right back with second quarter action.
It's almost time for school to start back. Do you have the money you need? If not, see our friends at Basic Finance in Shelby. If you need cash for back to school, Basic Finance in Shelby can help. They are behind you with the money you need. Come by their office today. Basic Finance is located at 306-2 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby, right across from Shelby High School. Call 704-481-0111. Remember, golf on Saturday, church on Sunday. $600 down delivers. That's right, $600 down delivers at Blanton Cars in Shelby. If you're looking for the best deal on pre-owned vehicles, come to Blanton Cars and pay $600 down on selected vehicles. Blanton Cars makes car buying simple. All you need is proof of residence and income. Buy here, pay here at Blanton Cars in Shelby. Visit one of the two locations, 325 West Dixon Boulevard in Shelby and 1711 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby. Online at BlantonCars.com.
Back to Shelby High School. Start of the second quarter. Franklin, second down, 8. Pass in the flat is complete to Nugent. And great job by Aaron Jolly to get there and tackle him for a short gain. Nugent fought as if he didn't think his knee went down. But they're marking him down at about the 33. So maybe a gain of just 1.
And as you mentioned, you know, Franklin does not have a first down. I mean, Franklin, we are now 11:37 left in the first half. Franklin, third down and 7, still looking for that first down of the night. Shelby has only 8 first downs but 4 touchdowns.
So it's 11:25 to go here, second quarter, and Moore back to pass on third and long. And again, complete, and again, Shelby all over it as Dax Hollifield makes the tackle.
And we got a late flag coming in. You got to wonder if Shelby's going to be guilty of a face mask because there's nobody there except Shelby defenders. And Dax Hollifield got a report from the official, and he's not happy. And so they are going to get that first down of the night, and it's going to be on a penalty on Shelby.
First and 10, and Kleppel was the receiver on that, but he only got 2 yards. So they've completed just 3 passes for 6 yards total. But big 15-yarder, and Shelby – they've looked good, Coach, but they are piling up some penalty yards tonight. It's at least their second 15-yard penalty, and I know they've got a hold and a couple of offsides, and now Shelby goes across the line of scrimmage, and that's O.J. Ross, and it might be 5 more against Shelby. Not only that, but it was a little excessive on the end of that one. First and 5 is now. Franklin ventures into Shelby territory for the first time tonight. They're at the Golden Lions 45-yard line.
Yeah, Shelby was 67 penalty yards already, and that has been a problem, you know, for the year.
So under center is Moore. Hard count. Shelby stays put. Clock continues to run. Play clock's at 5, and it's going to be Kleppel off left side. He gets a yard, and he fell forward for a yard as he was hit by – who is that, Rajay Kirkland or Jalen Scott? And so Scott hit him right at the line of scrimmage. Kleppel barrels for a yard forward. And he's got 4 carries now for 5 yards. 1,976 yards on the season. So that's what we're talking about, folks. The fact Shelby's held him to 5 yards. So far, that's a win for the Golden Lions. Second down, 4. Ball to Shelby, 44. In motion goes Nugent. Now it's a handoff to the fullback on the trap, and he gets 3, so it's going to be 3rd down and 1. I couldn't tell. That was Dave's 35. So it's going to be 3rd down and 1. That 5-yard penalty on Shelby on 1st down is big right now because it's making it 3rd and 1 versus a 3rd and 6. And you got to be thinking 45 here, but – you also got to respect that fullback. And now the quarterback, Moore, keeps it. And second effort may have gotten him to the 40. As he really fought hard and stretched that ball out. And they're going to give him a one-yard gain. And, that was second effort. So first down. The second first down for the Panthers on this drive. Both of them helped by penalties. The first one, the penalty gave them the first down. This one, the penalty gave them first and five. And then they made it on their own. So first and 10 at the Shelby 40. 9:09 to go. First half, Shelby 28, Franklin nothing. Nugent in motion. Hand off. No, it's a fake. Play action and back to pass. And he's got a man wide open, and it's just out of the reach of, I couldn't tell if that was Dave's 35, but he was not covered.
Yeah, they do a really nice job of sneaking the fullback out into the flat, and that was really past the flat. That was an unusual pattern because you don't generally see a man that deep as the secondary receiver, but the ball was just overthrown. And part of that reason it was overthrown was you'll have a tendency to throw that ball a little bit high when Dax Hollifield is barreling down on you about to hit you really hard. And I think they're going to say that Dax has some blood or something, and they're going to make Dax lead the field here, I guess, to bandage up a cut
Brandon
on his
Davis.
Arm.
Davis will come in for him. And you're right, Dax with some pressure. And that was actually A.J. Carpenter out that the pass was intended for, not Dave's. And Carpenter did get his hands on it, but he had to go high, and it just off his fingertips. So second and 10 for Franklin. Really nice play, just didn't connect. And now it's a handoff to the fullback, Carpenter, and he's hit immediately again. And, that was Brandon Davis and Joslyn McGill. And McGill's helmet comes off, so he's got to come out. And Kirkland in for him. Davis out and Hollifield back in. And they gain a one for Carpenter.
Well, I can tell you this. I know Franklin has not seen a half like they've had so thus far. There have been no holes to run in. And any kind of gain that they've gotten on the ground has been just due to fantastic running. But there have been no holes to run through.
Third down, 9. And there's Kleppel, and he does cut back, and he's fighting. Man, he's fighting for some yards. He would not go down. Shelby had him for about a 3-yard gain, and his second effort got about 7.
So it's going to be fourth down and 1 now, and obviously Franklin's going to go for this. We're down to 7:47, clock still running. It's fourth down and 1. Franklin on the Shelby 31-yard line. This has been the best drive, obviously, of the night for Franklin. Looking for their third first down. Shelby still leads 28-0.
And Shelby with a six-man front, and I think Franklin's going to call. Oh, it's a sideline warning, I think, on
yep.
Franklin. Well, so I think the Shelby sideline thought it was a timeout, but it was a sideline warning on Franklin. So fourth down and 1, and it's a full 1 yard they've got to go. They've got to get it to the 30, and they're on the 31 squarely.
This is when they've really shown the desire to give the ball to the fullback because everybody's expecting Kleppel to get it. But earlier in this series, they did a quarterback sneak.
And now they do call timeout. So we'll take one, too. We'll be back. We'll take a 30-second break so we don't miss this four-time play. Back right after this.
At James River Equipment, home with a 10-year, 1,000-hour tractor warranty, we don't just offer great deals on John Deere tractors. We have great deals on John Deere mowers, too. For a limited time, get a commercial-grade zero-turn John Deere Z915V mower for just $69.99. With a 25-horsepower engine, hydrostatic drivetrain, and 60-inch deck, mowing your yard has never been this fast or fun. Visit JamesRiverEquipment.com. Offer ends October 31st, 2016. Restrictions apply. See dealer for details.
Cool. Back to Shelby High. 28-0 Shelby. 7:11 to go second quarter, but Franklin on the move. They're at the Shelby 31-yard line, but it's fourth down and 1. And Panthers showing that they're going to go for it. Monroe leads Mount Pleasant 14-6. High Brighton 28, Burns 7. We'll keep you up to date as we can. And on fourth and one, they give it to the fullback, and he's got two. He needed one. First down, Panthers. And that's 35 Daves.
So that will be the first time that they've actually got 10 yards on four downs. But nice drive here. So it's first and 10. Franklin's got the ball on the Shelby 29-yard line. And again, they're back in the I formation running their offense. Shelby still leads 28 to nothing. 7 minutes left in the first half.
And in motion goes Nugent. And handoff to Kleppel. And he's fighting through. He broke a tackle and got four. You know, and down on the field is Dax Hollifield. He's holding his shoulder, and he's really looks like maybe he got a stinger on that shoulder, and he comes out, and in comes Brandon Davis. I think Dax wanted to stay in, but coaching staff pulled him out. 4 yard, and you see Kleppel right there. He was hit sort of a yard behind the line of scrimmage, and he just used his sheer strength to get 4 yards out of that.
I mean, we can see why he's got 2,000 yards on the season, because he hadn't had anything close to a hole to run through. And he still got, 15, 20 yards rushing thus far tonight?
Mm-hmm.
So second down and six, a short six.
Ball at the Shelby 25. Clock, game clock at 6:02. Play clock at 3. Nugent in motion, handoff fullback, and that's 35. Daves, and he's got close to first down yardage.
So again, third down and short. For the first time tonight now, Franklin is actually being able to run their offense, and that was actually a hole for the fullback to run through that time. That little quick trap right up the gut, and old buck trap that we used to run that all the time. And so it's third down and very short for Franklin.
Third and less than a yard. Handoff fullback, first down, and the pile still being pushed. So it was at the 21. Looks like he's got the 18. And that was 35 Daves again, I believe. When he turns, I'll tell you if it was. Nope, that was Carpenter, 31.
They are interchangeable, Carpenter and Daves, and they both run really hard. They are the same, pretty much the same size, 31, 35. Definitely most impressive drive of the night for Franklin. Four first downs, which is four more than they had going into this drive.
I think I jinxed the Golden Lions by mentioning that. First and 10 at the Shelby 18. Nugent goes in motion from left to right, now back left. Hand off Kleppel, off right tackle. He's hit low, spins, and then finally cleaned up. Short gain.
They're going to be about a 2 yard gain that time. Nice play design, because you got everything looking like it's going to the left, and then Kleppel breaking it back to the right. Not a whole lot of Golden Lion defenders over there, but the ones that are there made the play. And that's a play, if you don't make that tackle, Steve DeGree, he's going to score a touchdown. So that was a really nice tackle. Who was on that tackle? Damian Key, good tackle by Damian.
Yeah, he got spun around, and I couldn't tell who hit him low, maybe Davis or Stites. And now Kleppel, left side, and stood up by Carson and then finished off. So Carson got there quickly as he shed his block. Trey Darlington comes in the game. I'm not sure Kleppel got anything on that play.
Well, they've taken Dax's shoulder pads away from him, so Dax is still being looked at by the training staff, but he's got his shoulder pads off, his helmet off, and so we may not see Dax Hollifield again the rest of the night.
Dr. Bruce Cox over there tending to the shoulder. Third down and 8 as Carson stopped Kleppel for no gain on that play, and now back to pass is Moore. He gets heavy pressure, and he lost it, almost picked off by Davis, and then almost caught by Kleppel. Incomplete, though. And that was one of them that was almost great for Shelby, then almost horrible for Shelby, and it turns out just kind of neutral.
So it's going to be fourth down and almost 7, and looks like Franklin's going to try to get some points on this possession. They Their kicker is pretty good. In fact, he kicked about a 37-yard field goal to basically win the game last week. And so they're going to try a 33-yard field goal.
Edgar Chavez. And, you know, I guess here you got awesome, you know, respect the fake. And now they're trying to get a man out late, but that would have been too many. High snap. Chavez, he's got plenty of length on it, but it's wide right. No good. And Shelby dodges a bullet as they still have the shutout on the scoreboard. So missed field goal with 3:23 to go first quarter. Shelby still leads 28-0 on the Medical Arts Pharmacy scoreboard. And now the Golden Lions will take over at their 20-yard line.
Well, Franklin had that ball for almost 9 minutes and got nothing out of it. So this is the first time Shelby's had the ball in the second quarter. 3:23 left in the half.
So Shelby, I believe Coach has all three timeouts.
Two of them. They took one back in the first quarter.
Yep, that's right. Surratt back to pass all day, and he goes up top, and he's got a man. Oh, Jaden Borders, you don't see him miss very often. Styles hits him. Razy comes down, and I think maybe Jaden saw Styles coming full speed out of the corner of his eye because the throw was a little high. And
but generally the type of throw that he hauls in. I don't think he was seeing the guy coming to hit him. I think he was taking a quick look to see how he could dodge him once he made the catch, and he just didn't make the catch.
Second down, 10, 3:17 to go in the half. And Franklin shows blitz, and it's a handoff. Truck Sims, a spin move, and he's still on his feet, but he goes down. It's a gain of just about three. So good tackling there by 35. Oh, that's Dave, so he's in on defense as well. So Truck gets three, and now Shelby with third and long as they face third down 7. Just Truck's second carry of the game. He's got 30 yards on 2 carries. And Franklin shows potential blitz as Talent and De La Cruz creep up. 5 on the play clock, and Surratt back. They do get the blitz, but it's a quick slant, complete to Isaiah Etchison, and now he bounces out to the outside, 40, 45, and to the 47-yard line. Another great play call by Shelby, and another great execution by Surratt and Etchison.
Yeah, Shelby's doing some rolling the quarterback to the right and to the left, and the line is kind of like shifting over to the right to try to get outside shoulders, and they're doing a really good job with that particular blocking scheme.
That was a bullet pass, and that was a great catch by Etchison. First and 10, Shelby.
Empty set.
They do. 3 receivers right, 2 left. And pass complete to Malik McMullins, and Malik's going to run over would-be tackler for first down. Pegram Insurance first down for Malik. He gets 11. So that goes from the Shelby 47 to the 43-42 of Franklin. Gain of 11. And that's McMullins' first catch.
Got an official timeout. Not sure what that's about. I think they're going to say McMullins needs to come out of the game now.
So Jalen Cannon comes in, and indeed McMullins comes out. So first time we've seen Jalen Cannon tonight. So you got 3 receivers right and 2 left, and it's again an empty backfield. Truck Sims is in the slot left, and he's got Jaden Borders outside him, and then it's Jalen Cannon, Darius Fuller, and Isaiah Etchison on the right to the wide side. And Surratt, low snap, he handles it, and he's back. Now he rolls right, now he plants and looks back left. He's got a man open, but it's overthrown, and there's a flag down. 2 yards behind the line of scrimmage, and it's going to be a hold on Shelby. So Shelby just piling up the penalty yards tonight.
Got 79 yards of penalties on 8 called penalties.
And this is going to be another one of those 12-yard penalties, maybe 13-yard penalties, 13 yards. Nicely 14. So first and 24 for Shelby. Got to get all the way to the 33 of Franklin, and the ball's now on Shelby 44. And looks like Franklin into the neutral zone. No call. First down, 24. 23 and a half. Surratt rolls right. Plants. Delivers a strike complete to Fuller, and then Fuller drops it as he makes a move upfield, and they call it an incomplete pass.
Yeah, it was. I mean, he never really caught the ball. Looked like he was going to make the catch, turned around to run with it, but the ball never really was secure. And so it's going to be third down, and or is it still second down?
Second, and we'll call it 23. It's pretty close to 24. And Malik looks to the sideline. 10 on the play clock, 1:41 on the game clock. Shelby 28, Franklin nothing. And pass complete to Jaden Borders in the flat. He's got ahead of steam. 50, 45, 40, 35. And Dragon tacklers to the 30. That's a first down for Jaden Borders as he gets all the way from the Shelby 44 to the 30 of Franklin. So what's that, 26-yard
gain? 26-yard
gain.
It was a great run, but they're also great blocks. Again, Isaiah Etchison was one of those blockers. And who was the other blocker, Steve? I couldn't tell who it was. Fuller. Etchison and Fuller just did a great job of blocking. And you cannot give Borders that much room to run.
Pegram Insurance first down, and Malik looks up top. He's got heavy pressure, and he's going to go down. Does a good job to hold on to the football. He pump faked and wanted to go up top, but 28. McCall had good coverage on Fuller. He didn't bite, and so Malik then tried to pull it down and look left, Coach, and he just had too many guys there.
Shelby's going to take their second time out of the night.
All right, we'll take one, two, back in 30 seconds. Shelby leads 28-0 on the Medical Arts Pharmacy scoreboard.
Charge it up at Okie's Tire and Recapping in Shelby. Okie's Tire and Recapping in Shelby is now your battery test and electronic charge specialist. And they carry Interstate and Napa Legend batteries. And don't forget about tires. Name brands like Michelin, Yokohama, Firestone, Maxxis, Duro, and Goodyear. Used tires are available too. Compare their prices and you'll save money. Okie's Tire and Recapping on 800 West Warren Street in Shelby. Cleveland County's hometown tire store for 32 years.
Back to Shelby High School. Golden Lions call timeout. 1:13 to go here in the second quarter. Shelby's facing second down 15 at the Franklin 35-yard line after the 5-yard sack of Malik Surratt. Injury update, Dax Hollifield, is still on the sidelines. Looks like they're going to wrap up that shoulder and probably won't see Mr. Hollifield the rest of the game. But you never know. Dr. Cox is over here working on him. Second down 15, Surratt back. Complete to Isaiah Etchison at 35. Makes a good move inside the 30. Now he's going to be wrapped up and tackled, but he gets the 5 yards back plus maybe another yard or two. Now it's going to make it third and manageable. And really not a good spot. So he got to the 28 and then was dragged back, and they only give him the 30. So we'll call it a 5-yard reception. Third and 10. Might be four down territory. Surratt rolls left this time. Plants, and he's going up top. And he's got a man behind the defense, and that's Jaden Borders. And that's caught. And that's a touchdown, Shelby. Borders from Surratt, and that covers 30 yards. And Shelby takes a 34-0 lead over Franklin here with 38 seconds left in the half. And I just got to make sure that's number 6 on that catch. I believe it is. Ethan Triplett on for his 5th PAT of the night. And Malik Surratt's having himself a heck of a first half. He's got 4 touchdown passes. Darius Fuller to do the hold, and it's a good snap and hold, and the kick's up. And it's good, 35-0 Shelby, 38.5 seconds to go, first half. Take another timeout, and we'll be back with a Chase Hendricks Jammin' Jays Pizza Factory kickoff right after this.
Your holiday meal will taste better than ever if you cook it in a Butterball turkey fryer from Shelby Hardware. Select from electric or gas models. And Shelby Hardware has all your accessories, including basters, injectors, thermometers, and more. And see the selection of Primo grills, great for smoking your turkeys and hams. And keep warm with a new kerosene heater. And Shelby Hardware does kerosene heater repairs too. Shelby Hardware, 506 South Lafayette Street in Shelby.
Marburger Motors touchdown, 30 yards from Malik Surratt to Jaden Borders, and Ethan Triplett's PAT is giving Shelby a 35-0 lead over Franklin here. Still first half, but just 38.5 seconds left, and it's been all Golden Lions here in this opening half. And kickoff taken by McCall at the 8, and he tries to run across the field, and he's got a little bit of running room. He tries to cut it back at the 25, and the Keys chase him down. And, you know, you can't outrun the Keys.
No.
And proved to be true again as McCall tried to, and it looked good, but he just never got anywhere. He stopped at the 25.
Monroe's leading Mount Pleasant 21-6 in the second quarter. Have no score posted for RS and Huss, so we don't know what's going on in that game. Winner of this game plays the winner of the Huss-RS game. Got to feel that Huss would be favored in the game, but that doesn't really mean a whole lot.
Moore under center. Play action. He goes up top, and he's got Nugent, but overthrows him. Pretty decent coverage by Smith, and he also had C.J. Ross over there. That wasn't going to let anything happen. So, second down and 10 on the incompletion. 23.4 seconds left, first half. I've still got halftime score, West Rowan 14, Crest nothing. And I've got 35-13. High Brighton over Burns.
East Lincoln leads West Caldwell 20-7 in the second quarter.
Kleppel with a handoff. He gets 5. He got hit and knocked backwards 2 yards, but he got forward progress up to the 30. So that's a 5-yard gain. Third down and 5, and that may be the last play of the half. As the Panthers are going to let this one wind down. And at the end of 1, Shelby 35, Franklin nothing. We'll be back after a 3-minute break for our Okies Tire and Recapping of the first half and our Ronaldo Automall Halftime Show. We'll do that right after this break.
The foot doctors of choice for many in this area are Drs. Jeff Mooney and Ron Muscarinick at Foothills Podiatry. In fact, people come to Foothills Podiatry from miles around for gentle but state-of-the-art foot care. Our staff truly cares about your needs. You can expect top-notch medical and surgical care from a staff dedicated to quality service. Whether a repeat patient or a new one, come see us soon at Foothills Podiatry, 707 North Morgan Street in Shelby.
Homestead Landscape Supply and Feed Company has all of your landscaping and animal feed supplies. They are locally owned and operated by Todd and Nora Blanton for 16 years now. You'll find feed for all animals, also mulch, landscaping supplies, firewood, deer supplies, hunting supplies, and more. Located at 835 College Avenue in Shelby at 1836 Shelby Road in Kings Mountain. Open Monday through Saturday, 8 to 5. That's Homestead Landscape Supply and Feed Company. Call 704-487-7720 in Shelby or 704-734-0071 in Kings Mountain. Like them on Facebook, too. Have you got a ping-pang-ding going on with your car or truck? Then take it to A-Plus Automotive in Shelby. A-Plus Automotive does all types of automotive repairs, from tune-ups to oil changes and complete diagnostic work. And they are a North Carolina inspection station with over 30 years of experience. See A-Plus Automotive in Shelby. They also do AC and heater repair. Get her running today with a stop at A-Plus Automotive, 1900 Elizabeth Avenue in Shelby. See Charlie Heston today or call 704-482-0441 for A-Plus Automotive in Shelby. Get it on, bang a gong, get it on. Campers Inn in Kings Mountain and the Kings Mountain Police Department presents Kings Mountain's first annual Camping Out for Kids Holiday Bike Drive, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, December 9th through the 11th. Campers Inn in Kings Mountain will be camping out to collect new bikes for children in our community. They are looking to collect 150 to 200 new bikes from toddlers to teens. They do all the work, including the assembly. Just drop it off at Campers Inn in Kings Mountain. Make Christmas brighter for a child this Christmas. Campers Inn, Highway 161 South and I-85 in Kings Mountain, or campersinn.com. Gamble's Auto Service at 104 South DeKalb Street in Uptown Shelby is your one-stop service center for repair work on your auto. Locally owned and operated since 1980, they offer light and medium automotive repair on all types of vehicles. Bill Gamble and his friendly staff can do state inspections, minor engine repair work, brakes, air conditioning, and heating service, timing belts, tune-ups, and oil changes, and lubrication. And now Gamble sells new and used tires. Stop by and let Gamble's Auto Service take care of your automotive repairs and servicing. That's Gamble's Auto Service, 104 South DeKalb Street, Uptown Shelby. Call 704-487-5079. The Polaris Full Throttle sales event is underway at Full Throttle Power Sports in Gastonia. Come in now and get up to $3,000 in rebates on selected Polaris models. Plus, get financing as low as 2.99% for 36 months. Plus, the Yamaha Holiday Sales Event is underway. Get 3.99% APR financing, plus up to $750 in customer cash. Find out the details at Full Throttle Power Sports, 100 Indian Walk off I-85 in Lowell. Monroe Tire and
back to Shelby High School. 2AA second round playoff action. Shelby leads Franklin 35-0 here at halftime, Coach. And it's been all going Lions in the first half.
Well, you know, Shelby's had the ball five times. Shelby has five touchdowns. And it took till about the fourth drive for Franklin to get any first downs. In fact, they have four first downs. One of them was due to penalty. One of them was very helped by a penalty, and then they finally had two first downs that where they were able to just creep out 11 yards on four downs. And so it has definitely been all Shelby. And while you're finishing up the stats, I'll go ahead and do the Okies Tire and recap of the game. With 10:48 left in the first quarter, Truck Sims had a 61-yard pass from Malik Surratt. Triplets point after touchdown made it 7-0 Shelby. With 7:56 left in the first quarter, Darius Fuller had a 1-yard touchdown pass from Surratt. Triplets point after made it 14-0. With 3:53 left in the first quarter, Sims had a 27-yard touchdown run. Triplets point after made it 21-0. With 13 seconds left in the first half, Fuller had a 41-yard pass from Surratt. Triplets point after made it 28-0. And then with 38 seconds left in the first half, Borders had a 30-yard touchdown pass from Surratt. Triplets point after made it 35-0. Shelby has 12 first downs. And again, the only thing that you can be bothered at all by the Shelby first half is they were guilty of 8 penalties for 80 yards. Franklin had 4 first downs. They were guilty of 2 penalties for 10 yards. There have been no turnovers, but it has definitely been all Shelby. Franklin's gone for it twice on fourth down. Once when they were down 21-0 and went for it fourth down on their own 35-yard line and got nothing. In fact, lost some yardage, which set up Shelby's third touchdown or fourth touchdown. And then they went for it again on fourth and one and got it with the fullback up the middle. But it's been all Shelby. And, you know, we talked about, you know, the Shelby defense against the Franklin offense, and it's been all Shelby defense. I mean, Franklin's got 40-some yards total.
Yeah, I got him for 42. So pretty dominant first half by Shelby, and we'll just go right into the stats on that cue. So Shelby, Devin Gillette, 5 carries, 47 yards. Truck Sims, 2 carries, 30 yards and a touchdown. Malik Surratt, 2 carries, minus 3. So Shelby, 9 carries, 74 yards. And one touchdown. Passing Surratt, 14 of 19 for 259 yards, 4 touchdowns. Leading receiver is Jaden Borders, 5 catches for 100 yards and a touchdown. Isaiah Edgerton has 5 catches for 45 yards. Darius Fuller has 2 catches for 42 yards and 2 touchdowns. Truck Sims has 1 catch for 61 yards and a touchdown. And Malik McMullins has 1 catch for 11 yards. So 259 passing, 74 rushing, 333 total for Shelby. For Franklin, Brock Kleppel, 9 carries, 24 yards. Dylan Daves, 3 carries, 10 yards. A.J. Carpenter, 3 carries, 6 yards. Andrew Moore, 1 carry, 1 yard. Grant Stiles, 2 carries, minus 5. So that's 18 rushes for 36 yards. Moore is 3 of 10 passing for 6 yards. Completions, Dylan Daves has 1 catch for 3 yards. Brock Kleppel, 1 catch for 2 yards. And Jordan Nugent, 1 catch for 1 yard. So pretty dominant, Shelby. 333 total to 42 total for Franklin.
So now, Kleppel's run the ball 9 times. He's averaging 2.5 yards per carry. He's caught 1 pass for 2 yards. It's been a rough night for Kleppel. And you know, you can tell that he's a quality running back, but it doesn't matter how good you are. When you get the ball and there's nothing but black shirts in front of you, there's just not a whole lot you can do. And he's done a heck of a job to get 24 yards out of 9 rushes, because a lesser back would have nothing. Because there just hadn't, I could think maybe one time there's been somewhat of a hole to run through.
Yeah, he had the 8-yard run he had. He was hit at the line of scrimmage. That was the best run he had. The one I think you're talking about, he kind of went off right tackle and there was something there, but he got hit low, and as he was trying to pop up, he got hit pretty square by Davis, and that was about 5 yards. And you take, you know, aside from those two, it's just been 0-0-0-1-2, and he had to fight for everything he's gotten. So I've been impressed with how hard he's run, and he's broken some he's broken tackles when there was 3 guys holding him. So, but that, like I said, but he's only gotten 8 yards, 5 yards, 4 yards when he's done that. So that just tells you how good that Shelby's defense has been. And the fullbacks haven't really hurt Shelby either, as they've combined for 6 carries for 16 yards. So pretty good there too. And Shelby with a big lead, 35-0 at halftime. And got a visitor up here, Adam Weber. You know, he used to play down here on this field at one point.
I think I see Ralph Jolly also. So.
Ralph Jolly up here as well. So, tell you what, we'll take a little bit of a break and we'll come back. Maybe get one of these guys on the mic, and we'll do that after this break.
Service, a second-generation family-owned business serving Cleveland County for over 4 decades, is a complete tire and automotive service center, dedicated automotive safety and professional customer service. Staffed by credentialed service technicians with 300 years combined experience, they offer a 3-year, 36,000-mile guarantee on parts and labor, and a modern, relaxing waiting lounge. Monroe Tire and Service is located at 515 South Lafayette Street near Uptown Shelby. Stop by or call 704-482-8381. Monroe Tire and Service. Enjoy the ride. Renato Automall in Shelby is happy to announce their Christmas Families promotion again this year. You can help bring a little joy to a family less fortunate this holiday season. Just bring your non-perishable food items and unwrapped toys to Renato Automall and drop them off before December the 19th. They will be distributed to underprivileged families in our area. You can make a difference in someone's Christmas this year. Let's fill up a GMC Sierra pickup full of toys and non-perishable food items. Again, be sure to drop them off before December the 19th at Renato Automall, 4423 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby, right below the Cleveland Mall. November is Black Friday Savings Month all month long at Hendrick Appliance in Shelby. How about a big GE kitchen appliance package, including a refrigerator, over-the-counter microwave oven, electric range and dishwasher? All 4 pieces, $13.49, you save hundreds of dollars. A GE washer-dryer pair starts at $3.59 each piece, and a Samsung 25-cubic-foot refrigerator, MSRP $25.99, but now just $13.99. You save $1,200 at Hendrick Appliance, 1241 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby.
Name brand tires at prices you'll love from Okie's Tire and Recapping in Shelby. Name brands like Goodyear, Mastercraft, Michelin, Yokohama, Firestone, GT Radial, Duro, and more. Plus, Oakey's Tire and Recapping in Shelby has used tires. Compare their prices and save. Road service is available too, and they'll rotate and balance your tires for the lifetime of your tire. Oakey's Tire and Recapping, 800 West Warren Street in Shelby, Cleveland County's hometown tire store for 32 years.
Christmas at the Pond is back. Open every Friday and Saturday nights from November 25th till Christmas from 6 till 9 p.m. each night. Bring the entire family for a night of light shows and walking tours. Admission is $6 with kids 5 and under free. Plus hot chocolate and apple cider and more will be available. Christmas at the Pond is located at 1968 Kendricks Road in Shelby. For more information, call 704-473-3902. Christmas at the Pond. Every Friday and Saturday nights from 6 till 9, November 25th through Christmas. Like them on Facebook, too.
Back to Shelby High for our Ronaldo Auto Mall halftime show. Brett Pasco here. Jeff has stepped out, and we got a special guest, former Shelby High wide receiver, record-setting wide receiver, Ralph Jolly. Ralph, welcome back to Shelby High tonight.
It's great to be here. Great to see everybody.
So what do you think about the first half here by the Golden Lions?
To be honest, I'm not even surprised with the spread offense. I know they're going to make big plays every single game. Defense has been playing lights out, so I'm just proud to see them playing really well.
So Jaden Borders had a big first half. He had 100 yards receiving. Did you get a chance to play with Jaden at all?
Well, when he was a freshman, I was a senior, but I practiced with him and everything. I always knew he was going to be, to be honest, better than me. I knew he was going to be something special. So I'm just glad to see him out here, and it's good to see him going to the next level next year.
No doubt. Jaden committed to East Carolina. And, Ralph, you were able to get on the field this year for Gardner-Webb, so tell us a little bit about your season.
We had a pretty good season this year. We lost a couple close games, but overall I think we had a pretty breakout season. For me, I was able to make some plays, stay healthy all year. And I'm just looking to build on that in the future and try to elevate my game to the next level next year.
Well, that sounds good. So next year, what year were you this year?
I was a redshirt sophomore.
Redshirt sophomore. So 2 years left?
2 years left, yes, sir.
All right, we'll be pulling for you hard over in Bowling Springs. And it's good to have you close to home, too, so your family can go see you play and we can get out there and watch you as well.
Yes, sir.
So what do you think about the second half? Does Shelby Shelby kicks off. So big stand by the defense. And do you think it's going to be a running clock the second half?
I think defense is going to go three and out. Offense is going to get it back, score a few more touchdowns, and I think the second team will get in there, try to get some good experience. They can. Yes, sir.
So you got to play with RJ, and you got to put up some pretty good stats with RJ, and then Darquez came on and put up 60 touchdowns last year.
In one season, yes, sir.
So Malik's not going to have the kind of touchdowns, but Malik's got the second most touchdowns. He's got 37 now on the season. Of course, Darquez was 60 last year.
Yes, sir.
That may stand for quite some time, but what are you seeing on Malik as far as, you know, you got to play with RJ, you saw Darquez some as a backup when you played, and how does Malik, does he look to be the next great Shelby quarterback?
I would think so. I mean, it all starts with a good O-line to be able to run or pass, but also over the past few years, Shelby has just had some great receivers that make plays, and for the quarterback, if you just throw it up, when you have receivers that make plays like that, it's a lot easier to get the job done.
Well, the senior class, so Ralph, you got one ring?
Yes, sir, one ring.
So this senior class has a chance to go 4-for-4. Of course, they got to win tonight, and they got three more games they got to win, but they've got a chance, and that would be something special to say you played 4 years and you got four rings.
It would be. The way they're playing right now, I have pretty much no doubt they'll get the job done.
Well, let's hope so. And Ralph, we appreciate you coming up here tonight. And, again, welcome back to Shelby High. Great to have you on our halftime show here.
Yes, sir. It's always great to be here.
Yes, sir. We'll take another break, and we'll come back after 2 minutes. We'll have a second-half kickoff. Shelby leads 35-0 over Franklin on the Medical Arts Pharmacy Scoreboard. Back after this.
For over 40 years, the Barnett family has been serving delicious food. From yesterday's Barnett's Beehive to today's Barnett's Restaurant, hamburgers, including the Queen Bee, hot dogs, pork chop sandwiches, fried chicken and fish, plus meat entrees, vegetables, including the best potato wedges in town, and more. Barnett's Restaurant is open 10 a.m. to 7 p.m. Monday through Friday and 10 to 4 on Saturday. Call-ins are welcome at 482-3746. And Barnett's wishes Burns, Crest, and Shelby good luck in the playoffs. Barnett's Restaurant, Highway 180 North, Shelby.
Welcome to the Gentleman Cafe at 126 West Gold Street in downtown Kings Mountain. Gentleman Cafe offers a unique and relaxing atmosphere to enjoy while dining, or simply dropping in to sit for a while and enjoy one of their own brewed herbal tea blends. Their dining menu includes a variety of healthy and delicious foods, such as grilled panini, wraps, artisan sandwiches, homemade soups, salads, and more. Try one of their freshly juiced vegetable and fruit combinations or an all-fruit smoothie. The Gentlemen Cafe, 126 Gold Street in Kings Mountain. Call 704-750-6112.
Getting ready for the second half kickoff. That's going to conclude our Ronaldo Auto Mall halftime show. Our players to watch in the first half, Dax Hollifield. Called his name a few times, then he got that stinger on his right shoulder or some type of shoulder injury, and we didn't see him back on the field after that, coach. And then Devin Gillette was my player to watch on offense. He had 5 carries for 47 yards. He was a little bit overshadowed by some big plays that others had, but a decent half for both players. And getting ready for the second half kickoff, Shelby will be kicking off from the field house side towards the other end zone, and Chase Hendricks has it teed up for a Jam and Jay's Pizza Factory kickoff, and this is going to be taken at the 11-yard line, and I believe that was McCall, and he's going to be tackled out of bounds by one of the keys again at about the 30. So they'll take over right there, and Shelby's done a great job of limiting the kickoff return yardage and making Franklin go a long way.
Huss does lead Central halftime 7-0. Defensive battle. Huss has 117 total yards. RS has 52 yards total. And we'll keep you up to date on that. I'm going to go out on a limb and say Shelby's going to win this game. So Shelby's going to get the winner of the Huss-RS game.
A little different look. They're in sort of a pistol. And then Kleppel goes in motion out of that. And they look to him, and good thing it was thrown a little bit at the outside because C.J. Ross had a beat on that one. It falls incomplete. Second down and 10. And, Coach, that was like almost a pistol formation with the two running backs on either side of Moore. And then Kleppel came out of that and went in motion to the right, and then they tried to throw to him.
Well, Dax Hollifield's on the sideline. He does not look happy because they're not letting him have his shoulder pads. They're not letting him have his helmet. And I think that that's a situation that he could have played if it was a situation where Shelby was worried about the second half. But I think it makes a lot of sense to hold him out. They had him set up with a brace that would hold that shoulder in. But again, why use him right now when you're up 35-0? They did run the trap play up the middle to pick up 7 yards that time, so it's going to be 3rd down and 3 for Franklin.
And that was Carpenter. They sent Kleppel in motion again. This time Nugent goes in motion right to left, and Kleppel gets the handoff off right tackle. And nice play by Jalen Scott, but I think it was Brandon Davis actually that made the first hit, and that's going to be no gain for Kleppel and bring down 4th and about 2.5 in a decision time for Franklin.
Well, I fully expect him to go for it.
And that, with the spot, it was no gain for Kleppel. So he's still stuck on right on his 2,000 yards for the season, unofficially. 10 carries for 24 yards tonight. And 4th down 3, they're going to go for it. Got to get to the Shelby 40. Kleppel in motion, empty backfield. Moore backs up, gets heavy pressure, gets rid of it quickly. Almost picked off by Josh Smith. And was that Trey Jolly or that got in there? Or Warren Eskridge? I couldn't tell. That was Trey Jolly that made the hit on Moore and made him get rid of it. So it's turnover on downs. And when you don't make it and you go for a four, on fourth down, coach, and you're on your own 37, you got to take your poison. And that's Shelby getting the ball at the Franklin 37-yard line, already up 35-0 on the Medical Arts Pharmacy scoreboard. Malik Surratt in, two receivers right and left. Truck Sims is the lone running back. And in motion goes Jaden Borders. Now he'll get the pass, and he's got a wave of blockers. And he's at the 30, cuts inside, 25, 20, cuts again, 15, 10, and he's going to go in for the touchdown. Touchdown, Shelby, one play, 37 yards, Jaden Borders. And it's a touchdown, and Borders having a great game tonight. It's his second touchdown. He's well over 100 yards. And the Golden Lions take a 41-0 lead here with 10:23 to go in the third quarter. And that just means that the clock should start after this extra point, pretty much run the rest of the game. Tripling off for the point after. Good hold on after a tough snap, and he hooks it wide left. No good. So Shelby leads 41-0 on the Medical Arts Pharmacy scoreboard. We'll be back right after this for another Chase Hendricks Jamma Jay's Pizza Factory kickoff.
The Roundup Store in Shelby welcomes Burl Turner to their new Window and Door Planning Center. The Roundup Store can meet your needs for replacement windows or for new construction doors and windows. They offer wood, steel, or fiberglass door units and vinyl, wood or clad windows for new construction. They offer vinyl replacement windows in any size. That's the Roundup Store, 1610 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby, for all of your window and door projects. Call 704-482-7431. Again, 704-482-7431 for the Roundup Store in Shelby.
Marburger Motors touchdown, this time 37 yards from Malik Surratt to Jaden Borders, their second hookup of the night. Fifth touchdown pass from Malik Surratt. Shelby leads 41-0 on the Medical Arts Pharmacy scoreboard, and Chase Hendricks has it teed up for another Jamma Jay's Pizza Factory kickoff. And Franklin calls timeout.
Yeah, that's unbelievable. I don't think I've ever seen timeout called on the kickoff return.
They told him to run the clock. They told him to run the clock.
All right, so Shelby with over 40. And does the other team have a choice if they don't want it to run? I'm not sure.
That's just bizarre.
So now they come to talk to Coach Ware, and now they are going to run the clock continuously. So White Hat just gave the signal up to the press box, but they didn't seem to get the message because the clock has not begun to run. Maybe they'll start to run it on the kickoff. So now Hendricks with the Jamma Jay's Pizza Factory kickoff. And this one kicked low, but over the head and into the end zone, and that's going to be a touchback. So Franklin will start at the 20. They trail 41-0. The clock is still not started. So we'll see.
All right, Brent, here's a question for you. Does Shelby give decals anymore? Does Shelby give decals? Because, you know, generally by this time of the season, helmets are pretty much full of decals, and we're so far away, I don't see a whole lot of decals on the helmets. Steve, do they give decals?
Have given to kids.
First and 10. Pass nearly picked off. Intended for Nugent and high off his hands and then off CJ Ross's hands. Incomplete second down and 10. And Moore has missed on his last six pass attempts. And just 3 of 13. And this is a guy with a 60% completion rate on the season. Of course, he has hit a couple of receivers that in the hands that they haven't been able to come up with it. Nugent in motion, and Moore back to pass again. He looks left, and he lofts it up and nearly picked off again. And that was Damien Key in coverage on Kleppel out of the backfield. So they roll right, and Kleppel kind of leaks out left, and then he looks back left, but Key with great coverage over there. And it's going to be second down. third down and 10 for Franklin. Clock at 9:03, and we'll continue to run the rest of the ball game. And Kleppel in motion again, and a handoff on the trap. And this time, Brandon David, or actually, that was Will Stites that comes up. I almost called him something else, but I stopped myself. And so, short gain by Carpenter as he gets three. And on fourth down, they are actually going to punt. Fourth down and 7 for Franklin. 8:23 to go in the third quarter. Back for Shelby is Isaiah Etchison and Jaden Borders. They're both at about around the Shelby 40 to 45 yard line. And Moore to do the punt, and he kicks it over Etchison's head, and Etchison touches it. Now he has to pick it up on the third bounce. And he's all the way back at the 20, and now he's running across the field. Big block coming by Borders. And there goes Etchison. He's up the sideline, 45. And he's tackled hard by the quarterback, Moore. He was really picked up in the air and pile drive down. But what a return by Etchison.
That was about a 60-yard punt. And then a great return by Etchison.
And then a nice tackle by Moore. But Etchison all the way up to the Shelby 48. He retreated all the way back inside the 20. To get that ball, and he bumbled it around a few times and probably didn't even come up with it till he's around the 15. Reverse field, got a couple of good blocks, one from Truck Sims, one from Jaden Borders. Jaden's looked like it could have been highlight reel material, but he sort of backed off a hair. And now Truck Sims in at quarterback, and Shelby with the tight end, and it's a handoff. Jock Washington into the ball game, and he gets 2 to the 50. So second down and 8, and it looks like Shelby going to get take no chances with getting anything with Malik Surratt or with Devin Gillett, at least at this point. Second down, 8, ball on the 50, 6:39 to go, third quarter, and there goes Washington for another 3, tackled at the 47 of Franklin. Third down, 5 coming up.
Toward the end of the third quarter, Huss has scored again, so they lead RS Central 14-0 at this point.
Third and 5, Sims in the shotgun. Two receivers right and left. He's back to pass, and he's going to throw it, and he's got a man open, and that's Malik McMullins. And McMullins out of bounds. That's a first down. Pigram Insurance first down to the Franklin 38, and that's a gain of 9. McMullins' second catch of the evening. And Truck is 1 for 1 for 9 yards. 2 catches for 20 yards for McMullins. Fresh set of downs, Shelby. 5:45 to go, 41-0. Golden Lions, it's been all Shelby in this one. Sims in the shotgun, 4-man front for Franklin. Hand off to Washington, and he's got a hole. And there's a flag comes down. He's got about 10 yards on the play, maybe 11. To hold everything, holding on Shelby. So yet another 10-yard plus penalty on the Golden Lions. And that was after a nice run by Washington. The only good news was it was just a 10-yard penalty because they called it as if it was at the line of scrimmage versus in the backfield. First down, 20, and now the ball back at the Franklin 48-yard line. Clock continues to run. It's at 4:51 of the third quarter. And Truck Sims at quarterback. Jock Washington, the running back. I can't tell, but it looks like a couple of new receivers on the right side. Sims is going to pass it, and he's got a completion to Malik McMullins. And McMullins fumbles it out of bounds, but he gets about 7 yards back that they lost on the penalty. So actually, yep, we got 7. Second down, 13. Now that's 3 catches for McMullins on the night. And Sims is 2 for 2 for 16 yards. And this one may be over in a hurry again, just like last week.
Crest had a nice little drive, but they turned the ball over on down, so they're still down 14-0 against West Rowan with about 5 minutes to go in the third quarter.
Sims tries to hand it off. Now he reverses field. Now he's reversing his field, and he's going to take a huge loss back at the Shelby 48. And that's one of those plays where he just tried to do too much, really. And he lost, unfortunately, about 10 yards on the play. So it's going to bring up third down and 23 for Shelby. And it's also going to hurt Truck's rushing stats because he had two carries for 30. Now he has three for 20. Ball on the Shelby 49. 3:15 to go, third quarter. Shelby continues the big lead, 41-0. The clock's going to run the whole rest of the game at this point. And Sims rolls right, and he steps up, and he's going to throw deep. And he's got a man, and it was almost completed. I can't tell the number. And it was Rashard Green, and he couldn't come down with it. And it's going to fall incomplete and bring up fourth down, 23. And Truck's probably going to stay in and punt. And Shelby may even go for it here on fourth and 23. Ball on the Shelby side of the 50 on the 49. And so they're lined up as if they're going to run a play from the shotgun, but Truck can also kick it out of this formation. Snap back, and he is going to punt. And he gets the punt away. It's caught at the fair caught at the 18 by number 30. And Bukampong. And don't even ask me to spell that.
32-yard punt with no return. It really wasn't a fair catch, but he went down to a knee to catch it. And he was a very honest young man because when he went down to the knee, I don't know if the official was going to say he was on his knee, but he stopped as soon as he caught it. So first time for tonight that Shelby did not score a touchdown when they had the ball.
And the ball's taken over at the 19-yard line of Franklin. First and 10, Moore under center, handoff. And that was a new number. So let's see the number when he stands up.
I guess number seven.
Seven, Styles. So Styles gets maybe two, maybe three. Let's give him three. Second down, seven. And Styles gets three to the 21, 22. More under center, and it Styles again hitting the backfield and down at the 20, so he loses two of the three. And Kleppel's not in the game. Now, I've got him unofficially for 24 yards tonight, which would put him exactly on 2,000 for the year. It could be that they just want to make sure he gets his 2,000 yards and doesn't lose a yard. Maybe we won't even see Kleppel the rest of the game. Don't know. Loss of two for Styles is third down, nine.
West Rowan has scored again, so Crest is down 21-0 at the end of the third quarter. Not looking good for the rest of the SMAC conference right now.
Moore back to pass. He's got to complete this time to Nugent. Nugent's got a first down as he's out across the 35 or to the 40. And pushed out of bounds by C.J. Ross and Josh Smith. But the play gets 20 yards, and the biggest play of the night for Franklin.
And that'll be the end of the third quarter.
And at the end of three, Shelby, 41, Franklin, nothing. We'll take a one-minute break. We'll be back with fourth quarter action here at Shelby High School. All Golden Lions.
Medical Arts Pharmacy is your locally owned, independent hometown pharmacy. Unlike the big chain stores, Medical Arts Pharmacy calls you by name and treats you like family and friends, not a number. Medical Arts has more National Board certified technicians and personnel than other pharmacies to keep down your waiting time on prescriptions. Online refills at medicalartsofshelby.com. Medical Arts Pharmacy, 108 Grover Street near the hospital in Shelby. Call 704-487-8068.
Thank you.
Do you know what Putnam Distributor sells? Auto parts, truck parts, stuff for all sorts of equipment, plus 25 brands of motor oil, hydraulic fluids, filters, batteries, even nuts and bolts, and all at low, low prices. Putnam Distributors is located in downtown Patterson Springs, just 5 minutes from Kmart and the Cleveland Mall. Go south on Highway 226 or Highway 180 and just follow the signs. Putnam's prices are low on everything and for everybody. Call 704-487-9395 or visit them online at PutnamDistributors.com.
Start of the fourth quarter here at Shelby High School. And on first and 10, sacked for a five-yard loss by a combination of Michael Carson and O.J. Ross. And it's going to bring up second down and 15 for the Panthers. First sack of the night by Shelby. And Stiles gets the carry, and Joslyn McGill met him for no gain.
Huss now up 21-0 over RS Central with 11:48 left in the game. So looks like it's going to be Shelby and Huss next week.
The game will be right here at Pearly Allen Field, Blanton Memorial Stadium. 10:50 to go here, and the clock will continue to run. Shelby shuffling Shamez Poston in, I believe, for Damian Key. And pass complete to Nugent, and it's a double pass, and he goes up top, and he's got a man open, and it's just overthrown, intended for Robert McAllister. And he had maybe a half a step on Aaron Jolly on the trick play. But instead, it's Nugent with an incomplete pass, and it's going to be fourth down and 15. And I'm assuming punt for Franklin. And Moore is the punter as well as the quarterback, so he is back in punt formation. Fourth down, 15. 10:05 to go in the game. I've got a score that's a little bit old, but Clinton 14-7 over South Granville. Moore gets the punt away, and he angles it away from Shelby. It takes a Shelby bounce and then knocked out of bounds by Kleppel, who is in the game on the punt coverage. Shelby takes over at the 36.
29-yard punt with no return.
So last week we saw a little bit of back and forth between Nick Stites and Ja'Kalen Shell at quarterback, but it looks like Shelby's going to stay with Truck Sims. But I do see Donye Fuller in at one of the receiver spots. Rashard Green, Jalen Cannon in, also at receiver, and it looks like Shelby's one short, and there's 89. And I always forget which is which. It's one of the keys. It's Nathan Key. It's a 9, Nathan. I got to remember that. And hand off to Jock Washington. He's got a big hole. He's across the 45, still on his feet, out to midfield. And that's a gain of 14 yards by Jock Washington.
Steve says we've got an entirely new offensive line, so let's try to get some of those numbers. My voice is pretty much gone, and so that's why everybody's hearing Brent right now.
And I apologize for that, but we'll get – so Lake Barnes in at center. We'll get the rest of them after this play. Truck sends in the shotgun, 8:25 to go, ball game. First and 10 at midfield, Jock Washington, and he gets a yard, and that's about it. So I see 74.
And Chantez Banks.
Chantez Banks. I think I see 65, but that's Lake Barnes. 56.
Rashawn George.
Rashawn George. 70 is
Daniel Floyd. 72, Cedric Benson.
All right, so that's your offensive line. Second down, 9 after Washington pick up a 1. Ball on the Franklin side at the 49, and in motion goes Key, and he gets the pitch. He's at the 50. He turns it up, 45 to the 41. Pickup of about 8.
And loses his helmet.
And that's a pass, folks. So that's a gain of 8, and Sims gets credit for the completion. Third down, 1. for Shelby. And Washington remains the running back. And I can't see who's in the slot over there. But it's a handoff to Washington. He's got a first down and more. He's inside the 40 to the 36. So he picks up five more. Well, let's call it four.
It's good to see Jock Washington then getting some carries. I mean, he's had a he's had a rough year, you know, for a number of reasons, and it's just good to see him get in and get some good carries because he's such a hard runner.
He is. First and 10 at the Franklin 37. And again, running clock for the rest of the game. High snap, handoff, Washington. He's met in the backfield, and he just – that play just was kind of doomed from the start. It was a high snap. Truck had a little bit of a tough time getting it into the belly of Washington, and then when Washington did get it, he turned around and saw three white jerseys staring at him. Well, then he lost 1 yard. And that's a good call. Jacalyn Shell in at quarterback. So second down and 11.
6 minutes to go in the ball game.
And that may be MJ Allen in the slot over there. Keelan Surratt, 30. 32. And Donye Fuller. Okay. So Shell passes it complete to Green. Gets a great block by Cannon. And he's inside the 20. Still on his feet. And he's at the 15. And still on his feet. He's getting tackled back at the 17. So Rashard Green with a nice play, and that's a completion by Jacalyn Shell. So his first completion. Now I got to figure out where that got to.
Nick Stites in at quarterback now.
So that went from the 38 to the 17. So that's what, 19-yard reception?
21 yards.
21 yards?
38 to 17.
Yeah, pretty much 21 yards. And handoff to Jock Washington. He bounces it inside the 15. Gets a gain of about four. So that was a Pegram insurance first down on that catch by Green. So that goes from the 17 down to the 13. Gain of four. Second down, six. And Nick Stites in at quarterback still. New running back. Is that Fuller? Nope, that's Stites on the keeper. That's George Dunlap in. And Stites fumbles and is picked up by Franklin. And they're running the other way. And now they fumble. And Shelby's going to fall on it all the way back at the 38-yard line. I thought Stites' forward progress was stopped, and then they yanked it out from behind, and the nose tackle picked it up and started running with it. But he was way out, man, speed-wise by Shelby, who caught up, punched the ball out from behind, and then Shelby recovered it. So after all said and done, Stites has a run for no gain. Then there's a fumble, and he loses the fumble, and then Shelby gets it back. And now, with all that said and done, it's first and 10, Shelby at the Franklin 38 with 3:30 to go in the ball game, and Shelby up 41 to nothing. Fuller and Dunlap in at running back now, and Jacalyn Shell back in at quarterback. And both running backs move early, and it's going to be false start Shelby. Another penalty on the goal lines, first and 15. A lot of penalties, Coach, didn't hurt Shelby really in a game this lopsided. But as we've said all along, the farther you get, you can't have these kind of penalty nights.
Well, in the first half, they had 8 penalties for 80 yards, and they've had 2 penalties in the whole second half for 15. And so it's been much better in the second half. But you're right, Shelby's got to get over this penalty spree that they've been on for a while now.
Fuller gets a handoff on the left side. He bounces it inside 40, 35, and fighting to the 34. That's a nice 9-yard run. And I believe that was 32 Fuller. The PA yelled, call it Dunlap, but I'm pretty sure that was 32 Fuller.
So difficult to see the numbers.
Yep.
It's a really good-looking uniform, but the numbers are so difficult to read.
Second down six as I give Fuller nine. And now it's second down. Clock at 2:04. We're not going to have too many more plays in this game. High snap, handoff. Actually, it's Shell calling his own number, and he's got a first down. And he's out of bounds inside the 20. So Shell with a little trickery.
And the quarterback keeper steps out of bounds at the 20-yard line.
So that play goes for, he gets to the 19, maybe the 18. Got to see where they mark this.
They're going to have it at the 19, I believe.
All right, 19. So he picked up 15.
.120 left in the ball game. Shelby leads 41-0.
And now, I believe Fuller, and he's thrown out of bounds around the 11.
Carries around right in, brought down.
So he gets eight more.
Down inside, a minute to go.
It's one of those stat nights. A lot of guys here in this last couple of drives have had their hands on the ball. Green now in it, running back. And Shelby running the victory formation. So Stites will get it, and he'll kneel down. That's a 3-yard loss, and that's the last play of the ball game, I think. And it's going to be. So, all right, that's going to do it, folks. Shelby comes to the sidelines, and Shelby's going to move on to the third round to face the winner of Hunter Huss and RS Central, and we'll get you the update on that score in our postgame show. Final score here at Shelby High, Shelby 41, Franklin nothing. We'll be back in 3 minutes for our Bob Webb Homestar Financial Corporation in-stadium postgame show. We'll do that right after this break.
Here, lizard, lizard, lizard.
Oh no, it's total mayhem.
Hurry, call your good neighbor.
You can't. They're not even there.
Why, they can't even lend a good hand.
Oh. Relax. At Pigram Insurance, we've got you covered. Pigram Insurance Agency, 220 West Dixon Boulevard in Shelby and in the Town & Country Shopping Center in Lincolnton.
Kick off the savings at Essener Auto Sales in Shelby. Check out their huge selection of late model pre-owned cars, trucks, SUVs, and more. Ask about how you can buy here, pay here at Essener Auto Sales in Shelby. Visit the website for the complete inventory at EssenerAutoSales.com and pick up this week's WhatsApp shopper and play the Essener Auto Sales sports trivia. You could win a free meal from the new Creekside Clock. That's Essener Auto Sales, 408 South Post Road in Shelby, the home of the satisfied customer.
The easiest way home is with Homestar Financial Corporation in Shelby. Bob Webb invites you to come in and talk with one of their financial specialists about your new home, from conventional loans to FHA to VA and to USDA. And all loan programs are available to qualified buyers. Homestar Financial manages the entire mortgage process with outstanding customer service that produces a high level of customer satisfaction. Find out more today. Visit Homestar Financial Corporation, 306 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby, or call 704-482-2588. Want to cut your heating and cooling costs? With a high-efficient York heater or air conditioning system, you can save up to 50% on energy costs while enjoying more consistent temperatures throughout your home. Call Settle Heating and Air, your local York dealer, 704-481-1788. And schedule a free evaluation of your system and learn how you can move up to a new level of comfort and efficiency. Settle in with comfort with York and Settle Heating and Air, online at settleinwithcomfort.com.
Ooh,
If it's time to spruce up your home, then head to Cleveland Lumber Company in Shelby. Make your home look like new. See the new display of Larson doors, plus stair spindles by Crown Heritage. And for those patios and porch areas, Cleveland Lumber Company in Shelby has Trex flooring. Put it down and forget it. Plus all the tools you'll need if you're a do-it-yourselfer. Your home projects begin and end with a stop at Cleveland Lumber Company, 217 Airwood Street in Shelby. The new Honda TRX 12-volt ATV is now in stock at Honda Shelby. Available in red or black, it's the ATV for ages 3 to 6 years old. And now self-priced at only $299. Come on in and put one under your Christmas tree. While there, check out the big boy toys at Honda Shelby. See the Honda side-by-sides, the ATVs, the dirt bikes, cruisers, and more. Again, see the new Honda TRX 12-volt ATV for ages 3 to 6 at Honda of Shelby, 4402 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby. Call 704-487-7261. For over 30 years, Forest City Heating and Air has been serving Cleveland and Rutherford counties with quality-built Trane heated and air conditioning systems. Hurry in now and check out the great deals from Trane. Whether it's commercial or residential, Trane is there for you. Ask about their new Trane XL18i today. Come into Forest City Heating and Air for all the details. Call 828-245-1379. Forest City Heating and Air. Again, call 828-245-1379. And remember, it's hard to stop a Trane. At Marburger Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram in Shelby, they do the deals that the other guys just won't. They strive to do their best to keep you 100% satisfied. See the full line today, from new Chrysler 300 to a Dodge Challenger to the new Jeep Wrangler to the big Ram trucks. They've got it all. That's why people refer to them as the Marburger Powerhouse. Don't take it from us. Come see for yourself at Marburger Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram, 1310 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby, or online at MarburgerChryslerJeepDodgeRam.com. The American.
Back to Shelby High School. This is our Homestar Financial Corp, Bob Webb, Homestar Financial Corporation in-stadium postgame show here at Shelby High School. Shelby wins tonight 41-0 over Franklin on the Medical Arts Pharmacy scoreboard. Big night for the Golden Lions offensively and defensively, as they really dominated in both phases of the game and in special teams, with great coverage all night, some great returns as well. And Ethan Triplett was, what did he do? He was 5 for 6 on extra points. Chase Hendricks did a good job with the kickoff. Just an all-around dominating performance by Shelby. Once again, as 2 weeks into the playoffs, they've won 55-7. They've won 41-0. That's, 96-7 combined score. And they move on to the third round, Coach. And let's do our Okies Tire and recap of the ball game.
All right, with 10:48 left in the first quarter, Truck Sims had a 61-yard touchdown pass from Malik Surratt. Ethan Triplett's point after made it 7-0 Shelby. With 7:56 left in the first quarter, Darius Fuller had a 1-yard touchdown pass from Surratt. Triplett's point after made it 14-0. With 3:53 left in the first quarter, Sims had a 27-yard touchdown run. Triplett's point after made it 21-0. With 13 seconds left in the first quarter, Fuller had a 41-yard pass from Surratt. Triplett's point after made it 28-0. And with 38 seconds left in the first half, Borders had a 30-yard touchdown pass from Surratt. Triplett's point after made it 35-0. And in the second half, there was one score, 10:23 left in the third quarter. Borders, 37-yard touchdown pass from Surratt. And the point after was wide left. Snap was low. And did a nice job to get the ball on the tee, but you know how that goes when the timing is off, and that ball was just pulled to the left. And so Triplett had hit quite a few extra points in a row, and he's still perfect on field goals for the year. He's 8 for 8, and so we won't hold that against him. So it's 41-0 was the final for Shelby. Shelby had 18 first downs, 10 penalties for 95 yards, and one turnover a fumble late in the fourth quarter. For the game, Franklin had five first downs and two penalties for 10 yards, one turnover, and of course both the turnovers were on the same play, and just a dominant performance by Shelby. 28 points in the first quarter, and I mean, realistically, the game was over at that point. And I guess one of the strangest things I've seen is when Shelby scored to go up 41-0 and missed extra point, Shelby's getting ready to kick off, and the official then signals timeout, and he points toward Franklin with the timeout. Franklin coach comes on the field and obviously pointed out to the official that it was 41-0, and so the clock should be running. And, you know, I don't think I've ever seen that before, Brent. Is that the way you saw it? And
that's what I saw.
And it was just like Franklin said, okay, you know, this game is over with. Let's go ahead and get it over with as quickly as we can. Also a really interesting game in that many times once that clock starts running and all the you know, the second and third group comes in, you'll have a drive by the team that's behind, but that never happened. I mean, there was one first down in the entire second half by Franklin. And, in fact, the majority of the movement, you know, in the second half was by the Shelby second and third unit. And they really, you know, did a good job of moving the ball up and down the field. They only got – they weren't able to score, but Shelby had one punt for the night. And it was just a dominant performance by the Golden Lions.
Yeah, it was. Let's go over the stats for tonight's game. For Shelby, Devin Gillette, 5 carries, 47 yards. Malik Surratt, 2 carries for -3. Truck Sims, 3 carries for 20 yards and a touchdown. Jock Washington, 8 carries for 27 yards. Donye Fuller, 2 carries for 17 yards. Ja'Kalen Shell, 1 carry for 15 yards. Nick Stites, 2 carries for -3. Shelby with 120 yards on 23 carries. Passing, Malik Surratt, 15 of 20, 296 yards, 5 touchdowns. Truck Sims, 3 for 4 for 24 yards. And Ja'Kalen Shell, 1 of 1 for 21 yards. So that means Shelby combined was 19 of 25 for 341 yards and 5 touchdowns. Receiving tonight, Isaiah Etchison, 5 catches for 45 yards. Jaden Borders, 6 catches for 137 yards and 2 touchdowns. Darius Fuller, 2 catches, 42 yards, 2 touchdowns. Malik McMullins, 3 catches, 27 yards. Truck Sims, 1 catch for 61 yards and a touchdown. Rashard Green, 1 catch for 21 yards. Nathan Key, 1 catch for 8 yards. So what's that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 different receivers catching passes, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 7 different rushers tonight for Shelby. 461 total yards for Shelby tonight. 341 passing, 120 rushing. For the Panthers of Franklin tonight, Brock Kleppel needed 24 yards to get 2,000 yards. I have him for 10 carries for 24 yards. So congratulations to Kleppel for, if my yards are correct, he's at 2,000 exactly for the season. Dylan Daves, 3 carries for 10 yards. A.J. Carpenter, 5 carries for 16 yards. Andrew Moore, 2 carries -4. Grant Stiles, 5 carries -4. So I have Franklin with 42 yards on 25 carries. Moore was 4 of 15 passing for 26 yards. Jordan Nugent had 2 catches for 27 yards. Dylan Daves, 1 catch for 3 yards. Brock Kleppel, 1 catch for 2 yards. So I've got 42 yards rushing, 26 yards passing, 68 total yards for Franklin. So Shelby just dominant, 461 yards to, to 68 total for the ball game. And I don't know what else to say about it other than Shelby moves on to the third round against what looks to be Hunter Huss. Scores I've got, Coach, and you can correct if you've got an updated score, but I've got High Brighton 48, Burns 28. I've got West Rowan 28, Crest nothing. Hunter Huss 28, RS Central nothing. And I've got Monroe 21, Mount Pleasant 14. And that's the only scores I've got in front of me.
Do have an updated score. Unfortunately, High Brighton up on Burns 55-28, and that's with 11 minutes to go. High Brighton just scored to go up 55-28. And give me a second. I'll look for some other scores.
So looking at the brackets, looks like it's going to be Shelby versus Hunter Huss next week here at Shelby High School, third round action. And then, of course, a lot can happen on that other side where it looks like Monroe's got a seven-point lead on Mount Pleasant. Looking ahead to, I haven't seen a score from the other game on that side. And that would be the West Caldwell-East Lincoln game. So we'll see if we can get an update on that one from back at the studio. So I'll hit Kevin up and see if he's got that score. So tonight, Shelby 41, Franklin nothing. Let's look at the negatives, then we'll look at the positives. Negatives would be 8 penalties for 80 yards in the first half. East Lincoln up 34-7 on West Caldwell. So it looks like an East Lincoln versus maybe a Monroe matchup in the third round over in the other bracket. But Mount Pleasant's only trailing by 7 last we saw. So negatives, penalties in the first half, 8 for 80. And then I would say Dax Hollifield coming out with an injury to the shoulder and not coming back in the ball game. Although, Coach, it looked like he was making a case to come back in, maybe just precautionary with a big lead, not risking further damage and hoping he can be ready next week.
On that Monroe-Mount Pleasant game, it said Mount Pleasant just turned over the ball on downs, and Monroe has the ball inside a minute to go. So looks like Monroe's going to squeak out that win. Mount Pleasant is a really well-coached team. Coach Johns has done a great job with them, and we've run into them a couple of times in the playoffs, over the years. And I think the fact that he got to play Monroe a second time and got a chance to do a little scheming really meant that Monroe had to, go to the very end. And so it looks like they're going to win 21-14. They're going to play East Lincoln, and that's going to be a rematch from the state championship 2 years ago. Isn't that correct? Semifinals 2 years ago.
Yeah, I believe so. And, of course, Monroe, the defending UAA champs from last year, so they're looking to defend their UAA title. And, of course – looking way ahead, and I hate to do that, but should Shelby prevail next week, you could have the 2AA defending champs against the 2A defending champs in the Western Finals of the 2AA. So, of course, big game against Hunter Huss next week. A Hunter Huss team that defeated South Point and went undefeated in their conference. So, it's not just one of those games where Shelby's going to walk in there and have a running clock the whole second half like they have these first two round games. I expect a pretty athletic and really talented team from Hunter Huss here next week. So it looks like county teams not faring as well as Shelby tonight, and I'm sure everybody will get a chance to talk about that in the post game show with Kevin and Tom and Dennis and the crew back. And Terry, and I guess Steve Robe back at Studio Central. So we won't keep it here much longer. We'll give you guys a chance to call into that show. Again, tonight it was Shelby 41, Franklin nothing on the Medical Arts Pharmacy scoreboard.
Players of the game.
Players of the game. Let's do that. So made us a little fancy sheet here. So offensive player of the game, sponsored by Hendrix Appliance. And we're going to go with Jaden Borders. He had 6 catches for 137 yards. And 2 touchdowns in one of his best performances in the last several weeks. He's just putting up monstrous numbers all season and all career. He's every catch, every touchdown, he's just adding to his records that he's already got. And so Jaden Borders, our Hendrix Appliance offensive player of the game. Defensive player of the game is Jalen Scott. Had a great game, broke up several passes, got in the backfield. Really was the guy that was spying on Kleppel tonight and covered him out of the backfield a couple of times and made some big hits and kept him well under his season average. Jalen Scott, our defense player of the game, sponsored by What's Up Shopper. And our overall player of the game, sponsored by SNR Auto Sales. And we're going to go Malik Surratt I mean, what kind of stats are those? 15 of 20 for 296 yards and five touchdowns, and basically played one play of the second half in which he threw a 37-yard touchdown pass. And then so from 10:23 on, he didn't the third quarter, he didn't play. So almost 300 yards in two quarters of action and five touchdowns. So huge game for Malik Surratt. Really his best game of the year stat-wise, comes at a pretty good time in the second round of the 2AA playoffs. So those are our players of the game tonight. Coach, any final words before we head off into the sunset? Hope you get your voice back next week. That's the word from him. So for Jeff Jones and Steve Robay back at Studio Central, this is Brent Pasco. You've been listening to Shelby High Football here on KTCBroadcasting.com. Join us next week, 7 o'clock airtime. We should be on 101.5 FM as well as 1390 WHS and also here on KTCBroadcasting.com. Lincolnton up big, 62-14. Or 62-20 now. I just got that text from Kevin Hastings. Appreciate that from Kevin. So for our crew here, we're sending it back to the studio. Some of you can head over and listen to the end of the Crestor Burns games. And we'll see you next week here at Shelby High. Shelby and Hunter Huss.
Standard Excessive Celebration Sale.